true lovers of freedom, Biafran, all over the whole world. Like as you all know, good evening. I want to thank you all. My name is Mazi Okonkwo. Mazi Okonkwo is an IPOB under the auspices of our leader Mazi Nnamdi Kanu. I bring you greetings today, and I say may God Chukwuka Biama, the God of our leader Mazi Nnamdi Kanu, always be with us. Mazi Nnamdi Kanu is our leader. We are under him. Apart from Mazi Nnamdi Kanu, there is no other incorruptible leader that can lead indigenous people of Biafra to their destination. Mazi Nnamdi Kanu is the son of Biafra, the king and the prince and the leader and the only incorruptible leader who was kidnapped by Zoo under the help of British and Kenya. He was extraordinarily indicted and against his will. So that is why we are here. Please help me and join me to share this broadcast. This particular broadcast that I am anchoring this evening, this morning, depending on your time zone, is a program that can bring all the indigenous people of Biafra together. My intention of hosting this particular program for anyone who wants to join me is a platform for peace and harmony. This is not a platform to cascade one another. I also welcome all our enemies, and of course, everyone have his own mind and will to, of course, say what you want to say. But one of the promise that I'm going to throw down for anyone who have come here this evening to fight against my own platform, definitely, I promise I'm going to block you. And when I block you, your generation has been blocked. I want to thank all my comrades, my loved ones, those of you who have been helping me on my own forum to share this particular broadcast. I pray for you, those who are willing to reconcile themselves for the move to make Biafra come. I also want to tell us, please, on this junction, the WhatsApp line shall be open as soon as I say so. For many of you who want to join me on the StreamYard, to discuss on what I have titled, How Can We Get the Mind of the Indigenous People of Biafra? If you want to join me and to bring your own suggestion and to think how we can come together, distance is not a barrier. Only click the code and you can come in. As we are approaching, I see my sister Mercy Coco from Igodomigodo. I also see Shime Zeremu Okoro is here and many others that will soon join us. Please, 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 this broadcast is coming from Mazi Okonkwo Biafran TV. And as you have seen the title of this particular meeting tonight, what is your suggestion? What are we going to do to bring our people together? Who can talk to our people? Those are the things that we're going to discuss heart to heart so that we can be able to bring justice and love to one another. Biafrans are one, and this broadcast is not to open a room for enemies to come and judge us. I also want to say to some of the saboteurs who are looking into another man's family to judge another man's family, I want to tell you that you lose. You are behaving like a one who goes into a house and you're judging a husband and wife on their quarrel, or it doesn't matter if the husband and wife tells you their problem and you are supporting one of the family. When you turn your back, the husband and the wife are going to reconcile and you'll be left alone as a foolish man. Those people who are prognosing, looking for fight, looking how to join Biafrans together, cascading, blogging, what is happening in this, in IPOB, I want to tell you, you are a loser. We are one. Anything that we're discussing here is for the movement of the indigenous people of Biafra. And as long as you are not among us, you are against us. So you can hear what you want to say. At the end, we are one brother, we are one family. We must reconcile one another, but today is another different kind of topic. You're welcome to this particular program. Anyone who wants to join me, like as I said, I also see Nemeka Anyanwu is here. Say, my brother, I must tell you, causing problem in Dear Biafra. Then let me block your first daughter's generation immediately, and you are no longer going to exist. Like I tell you, as I block you, I have blocked your internal generation. I am here and you don't even know what I want to talk. Like as I told you, now I block you, I block your third generation. I see Lola, Obi, Nora Foster joining me already here. Thank you, Obi Foster, for joining me. Lola, you're welcome. And I see Messi Coco, my own person. I have blocked that Oluku. I am just opening my forum. He appeared like devil. I also cast him out like a demon and also block him once again and delete all his comments. Yes, he's no longer existing as long as I'm concerned. He is the one coming to cause problem. I am here saying something to unite brothers and sisters together, and such an enemy popping, what do I have to do to block his generation and block everyone? I told him before we start. So therefore today, why I am here is to expose a lot of things that could be the reason why many people still disobey the order of the DOS, as we said, as we see. Our DOS has given us an order, persuade us to stop the sit-at-home order. But there are still questions coming here and there, especially from the news and especially what we see today. We saw a lot of shops still being, I could say, market being open, but the same people are afraid of opening their shops. People decided to sit at home. Now, the problem is, if we can, thank you, Saint Kelechi Okole says, speak up. Thank you, my brother, for understanding me. Why we are here now is we want to know why are many people still, I could say, so many say it is disobeying the order of DOS. So many people say that people are not getting the news to continue staying on their shops instead of sitting at home. So many news are coming. Many lack information that the DOS under and at the command of our leader has opened up the market. Many get confused. There are many things going on here and there. Many get confused. So these are the issues that I want I and you to discuss tonight. If you want to come in, the link is there. When you click the link, I am going to bring you in to be here with me this day. But before we will start, I am going to play some of the clips that we got from the market today based on that the people back down there at home. The people in Biafra land has refused to go to their shops. Now, the question is this. What do they think? What do they believe? So many news, so many people say that they don't want to open their shops. So many say that they, no matter what the DOS says, they are still going to carry out the plans of sitting at home until Mazinam the Kano is released. Now, the question is this. Is it the problem of DOS? Are these people a registered members of IPOB? No. Is this issue the issue of Biafra's entirely? These are the questions at hand. So we have to look into it. Why is these people actually blocking the news that they should go to the market? These are the areas by which we are going to discuss tonight with you and I. When the line is open, I would like somebody to come in, to call in and give your suggestion, what you think that makes the people still open up for sitting at home. Now, the question that I'm throwing now is, are these people IPOBs, registered IPOB? Are they Biafrans? If they are Biafrans, simply means that the spirit of Biafran has gone to another level, on what we call the autopilot, as proclaimed by our brother Mazu Simonepa. Unknowingly, what he spoke have taken order. Mazu Simonepa on his broadcast one day spoke about Biafra movement getting into autopilot. And what I see here, if I have to really say something, what you see that is going on right now, trying to stop the seat at home, but men and women, brethren, market women, wheelbarrow pushers in the market, even some of the Okada riders, they have refused to go into their business. The question is this, why have they choose by themselves to sit at home? Even the order of sitting at home has been canceled by the leader of the indigenous people of Biafra, Akuse, and also the DOS. The question is this: what actually did the people think about sit at home? Many people say they are rebels. Many people say no, they do not want to, you know, obey the order. Many said, give us Mazen and the Kano, otherwise we will sit at home. Many said they don't trust the DOS and also the barrister who is seeing Mazen and the Kano. These are the issues that we want to discuss. But I know I also welcome some of the idiots here who are coming to say that I want to cause problem. Now, if these people, if our people, Biafrans, refused to obey the command of the DOS, what are we going to do? Who is going to speak to them to convert their mind to obey the order of the DOS? These are the matters arising. Do you want to join me? Do you want to call in to tell me what you think the reason why the people have choose to, I could say, some say, like I said, disobeying the order of the DOS. So many people say, no, it is because of the love they have of Mazen and the Kano. Many said that nobody trusts each other. Many said that even in Nigeria, you can't even trust the lawyer. Some say you can't trust even the DOS. So these are the matters arising. How can we talk to our people? Who is the man that can speak? Since many people do not believe or do not trust each other, do not trust Eastern Secret Network, do not trust even the lawyers, do not trust anybody. Now, the question is this: what and how are we going to really speak to our people? Somebody called me today and said, Mazi, to be honest with you, so many of us, our people, lack the media to know when the DOS put a new order. Many say no, they do not trust the zoo, that even they can stay in their shop, the zoo can come there and kill them and say that Eastern Secret Network. Many people are afraid. Nobody trusts each other. This movement has entered into autopilot. We are not saying that IPOB has entered into autopilot. I repeat, before you took my name to another ring. So today is another discussion. So I want people to come in. I want you to come and comment, come and say something. You can call on the telephone number, +316 871 86910. This broadcast will not be anchored by only Mazi Okonkwo here. I want people who knows how to put their thoughts into words. Come and tell us what you think on how we will reach our people to let them know that DOS has canceled the appointment. To let them know also how we, to let also the DOS know how to talk to our people so that we can be able to move forward. Then it's going to look like the Biafran does not respect the leaders, and that is not what we wish for anybody. Because this particular sit at home that people has put in the law into their hand is causing a lot of problems. So many people are prognosing. They don't know what to say. So many people leave the real thing that they're supposed to talk. Some of them are talking about Simon Epa, talking about Mazo Okonkwo, talking about Biafran broadcasters. Problem and the discussion in our house. We are one brother. Sometimes it happens. No, the reason, the main purpose is this, so that we can be able to block some of the chapters as we reason. Anything that we're discussing here is a family matter. Anyone who is coming outside, who is commenting evil here, is a son of Janjaweed, like the one have just blocked the destiny of their firstborn child here. So the lines are open. Our platform is open for you to come in. And by the way, let me begin to play some of the videos of the sit-at-home order. Thank you. And God bless you. Watch this video.
DS custody to create mildness from the people's heart, because there's no.
On Tuesday,
yeah,
after Bishop's conference in Owerri,
yeah,
they resolved that IPOB should suspend the every Monday exercise owing to at least that is biting hard on the economy of the Southeast. They said they now resolve that any day that Nnamdi Kanu will be coming to court, the sit-at-home will be affected. But unfortunately, people are not, you know, You don't have that covenant to come out. Auditing is responsible.
The problem is that the people that are resolving that IPOB should mire everything and people should come out, I believe they are in order by saying that the whole thing will be done like that. But there's something they forgot. People is already fearing. This is number one. And number two, people believe that Nnamdi Kanu is in DSS custody. Then number three, they should allow Nnamdi Kanu to speak from DS custody.
I want to make a comment based on what our brother have spoken here. I think this particular problem that you see, that people took the law into their hand, every problem that you see that this sit at home is generating right now is not only caused by both DOS or both indigenous people of Biafra. The situation is caused by the leaders and those who have kidnapped Mazen Nnamdi Kanu. And now this particular movement, this particular sit at home, has entered beyond the repair. And now every IPOB, every Biafrans are understanding ourselves to be an enemy. No, we are not enemy of each other. We should go back and look to the face of the people that generated this sit at home order. We don't care if it is DOS that announced it. We don't care if Mazen Nnamdi Kanu is the one who announced it. The suffer is going to the Southeast governors, so to say. And the reason why we are pointing it to be this way. Now it has entered into an autopilot, means uncontrollable. Everyone is fighting against each other. People are commenting, but we have to sit back and listen why, who created this problem. Those who created this problem are those who were able to kidnap Mazen Nnamdi Kanu. So I am also, from my own point of view, I am calling all the Southeast governors, Southside governor, those who are involved in ordinary rendition of Mazen Nnamdi Kanu, to also speak to the Janjaweed before Mazen Nnamdi Kanu could be brought into court to solve this problem. If it's Mazen Nnamdi Kanu, if it is Mazen Nnamdi Kanu that spoke from, that ordered this sit at home to be cancelled, and the people do not believe, because why? Mazen Nnamdi Kanu is in detention in the hand of the Janjaweed, and of course you know how terrible Nigerian government is. So the people have taken the law into their hand because they did not believe the people anymore. Nobody believes each other. People believe that the DSS or whatever cannot give chance for Mazen Nnamdi Kanu to even speak to his lawyer to cancel the sit-at-home order for the people to go to work. So now, those are the problem, those are the issues that we are discussing. The people that created this particular monster that is reigning all over the whole Southeast, the cause of this sit-at-home order, even when the DOS of IPOB cancelled it, and people still take law into their hand. According to our brother here, who is in the market, who is down there in the Southeast, said, if the people want the people to stop this or to continue going to the market, Mazen Nnamdi Kanu will speak from the prison. This is one part of the, I could say, the allegement, or how do I put it, one part of the complaint, one part of the wish of the people. People down there in the market who still believe that they will not stop the sit-at-home order, they said they need Mazen Nnamdi Kanu to speak from the prison. So if Nigerian government, if the Southeast governors, if Dave Umahi and the Wike want the sit-at-home order to continue to come to a stop, they must be able to speak to their DSS. They must be able to speak to the Nigerian government. Then they want Mazen Nnamdi Kanu to give us a broadcast so that all Biafrans and all, I could say, indigenous people of IPOB, we know that that command to stop is Mazen Nnamdi Kanu. But failure to do that, many people has put in the law into their hand and they have decided to be sitting at home. Now, the question is this. No one is able to control these people until Mazen Nnamdi Kanu speaks. And if our people continuously sitting at home, definitely this is going to affect the economy of the South, Southeast. So something should be done immediately if people want to create peace. This is not a time for fight. We have to now forget fighting at home and look into the eyes of those who have created this monster. When Simon Eba said that it has entered or it shall enter autopilot, this is exactly what he is talking about. When you breed a lion and you open the cage, the lion will simply go out and begin to kill a lot of people and devour a lot of people on the street. This is exactly what the Southeast Nigerian government has done. Now, Mazen Nnamdi-Kanu, you hold him inside, and you know that Mazen Nnamdi-Kanu is a leader of a powerful group in this face of this universe. Now, have you seen? They were thinking, these people who rendited Mazen Nnamdi-Kanu was thinking that when they rendit Mazen Nnamdi-Kanu, they will suppress him and kill him, you know, destroy him. But they did not know that the prophecy of Joshua Egilla is active and working. When you kidnap the leader, you have not killed the idea. The DOS can try as much as they can to organize this particular. They are doing good. We have fought against them. We have said a lot of things that are causing problems among us. But now the people have said to themselves that they don't want to listen to anybody, that what they want is Mazen Nnamdi-Kanu. They have been marginalized, and as a matter of fact, there is no trust even to the lawyer. There is no trust even to Nigeria. Nobody should trust. They don't trust the police. They don't trust the DSS. Have you seen what the bad system of Nigeria is creating to the South side? And not only the DSS. This is what we have come here to discuss today. We have to look to those who have created this, I could say, for someone not to believe each other. This is exactly what the Nigerian government has created. This is exactly what the Southern governor has created, that Mazen Nnamdi-Kanu is now inside, and nobody can be able to control this huge amount of people. Only the one who has built this group, Mazen Nnamdi-Kanu. So there is a demand that Mazen Nnamdi-Kanu should be released or give at least an open prison from where he can be able to talk and be able to control this particular huge amount of followers. Apart from that, people has made up their mind to be sitting at home. This is not a matter of DOS canceling it or IPOB fighting against themselves. The monster that the South governors and Nigerian government has created with the British and those who rendered Mazen Nnamdi-Kanu is the cause of the why people want to sit at home, because they don't believe. They want to see their leader before they can be able to believe, even the DOS. This is the consequence upon the fact. So the line is open. I am just playing this video. If you want to call in, you can call. The number you see there is a WhatsApp number. If you want to join me on this broadcast, you are welcome. So now let's listen to our brother more, and as he is speaking, please pay attention. Pay attention to this brother. Do not fight this program. If you come here and commit nonsense, I'm going to block you immediately. I see Hector Mark Shook say the call isn't on WhatsApp. It is on WhatsApp. You can call in. You can join me on my stream yard. No problem. God bless you. Now let's listen to our brother.
On Tuesday,
yeah,
after Bishop's conference in Owerri,
yeah,
they resolved that IPOB should suspend the every Monday exercise. Oyinjo Aliza is biting hard on the economy of the Southeast. They said they now resolved that any day that Nnamdi-Kanu will be coming to court,
yeah,
the citadel will be affected. But unfortunately, people are not, you know, don't have that confidence to come out. Audit is responsible.
The problem is that the people that are resolving that IPOB should mire everything and people should come out, I believe they are in order by saying that the whole thing will be done like that. But there's something they forgot. People is already fearing. This is number one. And number two, people believe that Nnamdi-Kanu is in DSS custody. Then number three, they should allow Nnamdi-Kanu to speak from DS custody to create mildness from the people's heart. Because there's nobody you can trust now. Even the there are people that say that they are DOS and the IPOP, there's a little confusion. So the...
You know, when you listen to this, our brother, he is saying it as it is. Thank you, my brother. Ejim Ebo said, I will live long. My brother, you will also live long. Those who wish me long life will live long life. Because I am hitting the truth. There is nobody to trust any longer in South South in Nigeria. Even the lawyer. The DOS will come, they can say anything they want to say. I trust the DOS. You understand? Because I am into oath. Even I cannot tell you that I trust them 100%. Even those who are oath members are still betrayers. So they should look into the reason why people does not trust anybody again. This is what the lion, the demon that the Nigerian government has they have grown up. That is why nobody believes his other any longer in the zoological republic. This is the problem right now. Nobody believes each other any longer. That is why you see people are fighting, doing anything now to release their leader, Mazen Nnamdi-Kanu. The love people have on Mazen Nnamdi-Kanu, according to my brother Hector, is too much, and it is unconditional love. Nobody can stop it. So now, what I am saying here, I am not coming here to fight the DOS, to fight myself, to fight those of us who are an oath member of IPOB. I am saying, let us look into the situation. Who creates this monster? It is the Nigerian government and the British government. The only thing they can be able to do right now to allow people, like Dave Umahi, who is fighting that he's going to give sanction to those. If you didn't come to work, I'm going to sack you. I'm going to destroy you. Those of you who are combination of the demons that rendered Mazen Nnamdi-Kanu, people, his followers, those who have shut down their shops, said the only way they can be able to open shop is they want to hear the voice of their leader. So the only thing that you can do now is to make sure that Mazen Nnamdi-Kanu speaks to the people of Biafra, people of IPOB, to speak to the whole world that he himself is the one who have said, release the shops, release, everybody should go back to the shop. Nobody believes each other. And they have accepted to be locking their shop until their leader, Mazen Nnamdi-Kanu, is first of all heard from anywhere he is. And they have said, nobody can stop it. And people said, I had people in Radio Biafra saying, you have been in a Radio Biafra for a long time. You don't believe our leader. Our leader is a man. He have changed it. Mazen Nnamdi-Kanu, they know, is a man who never changed from his word. We follow his broadcast. We follow everything that Mazen Nnamdi-Kanu have been saying. Mazen Nnamdi-Kanu said in one of the broadcasts that I know, he said, Biafra or death. That is why now, a lot of people that you see that have listened to the Radio Biafra, they don't believe any longer that it was Mazen Nnamdi-Kanu that I commanded and said everybody should go back to his shops. Because even me myself, I have never believed it. Even me myself, I am also a victim of not believing anybody because of the situation that Nigerian government has placed us. I don't believe, I don't trust anybody. That's why we say that everyone is a suspect. Now, I want to put you also through this man. Let's finish listening to this, our brother. He has a point. And the line, as I said, is open. If you want to join me, you can come in and join me on this particular platform. And let's discuss. Maybe people will hear your voice. This broadcast that I'm doing says, who can talk to our people? Who can advise our people to come back and believe what the DOS is saying? People say, give Simon Epa a chance to talk to the people. Maybe Simon Epa, because he's a great activist, loved by Mazen Nnamdi-Kanu, is the only one that can convince him. People say, no, give the other person a chance to speak to our people. People say, no, our people has never had it. People are lacking Radio Biafra. Some people say they don't have light to understand when the broadcast, it was lifted. Now, but the issue is this here. How and who is going to talk to our people to understand? Our brother made it clear here. It's only Mazen Nnamdi-Kanu. If Dave Umahi and those who contributed money, those Igbo men that contributed money for the rendition of Only the Mazen and the Canon, the only thing they have to do as fast and as simple to cause, to break this thing, since even the people do not believe, even the DOS, do you think the Southeast governor they are going to believe you? No, they are never going to believe you. They are never going to believe anybody until Mazen Nandekano's voice is heard. So now the question is this: what about tomorrow if they don't see Mazen Nandekano in the court? Then Nigeria will be broken into two. They are resolute. Biafrans are resolute. This is a symbol. This is a sign to show you that there is a smelling of terror and absence of Mazen Nandekano. Everybody should understand what is happening. Let us stop blaming ourselves and whether it is DOS we have to listen to. Now, we have to also look back and say and ask ourselves, who created this monster that is rolling around now? It is a monster. And this monster is going to cause a great damage in the South-South. Very soon, all the South-South governors is going to feel the heat of this Monday lockdown, which DOS themselves has tried to block, but the monster is still rolling around. Now it is going to be a very big terror to the South-South, the economy, and everything will go down. The people have determined. Now, this is the 2 weeks they refuse to go to shop. Many said until Mazen Nandekano speak to them anywhere he is, so that you can be able to understand that the autopilot we're talking about has taken his course without a man pushing it to order. All right? Now, let's listen to our brother continuously. Thank you.
Best, if Nigerian and Biafra wanted to do the best thing, let them allow Nnamdi Kanu to speak boldly.
Do you see her scanty everywhere is? Do you see that men and women are still refusing to go to work? Do you see what is happening in absence of Mazen Nandekano? In other words, if Mazen Nandekano, Nigerian government and the South-South governors, those who have kidnapped Mazen Nandekano, should understand that tomorrow they look for Mazen Nandekano, Mazen Nandekano is not there. Means that a lot of terror, means that you have created a double monster that they cannot be able to control. This is not about DOS said, Nandekano said, or Samonepa said, or this one said. We have to blame those who are creating the, who have created this evil. We have to blame those who have created this evil. This is number one video. I am still going to play another video for us so that everybody will see what exactly that's going on. Now, let's watch.
Come on, this since we the IPO people cancel their seat at home. And now we are with dinner, with their life for Banana Junction, with their for Olu for Imo State. So, with waiting they happen and then the fear of people, we don't see say business they don't open at all. People they inside their house and then park will be there for this place where they load away reserve. No motor park, nothing we happen at all. The place just dry. No least some resident way I don't talk with, they say do no fee come out based on say their life they important. And meanwhile then at the second Monday since we IPOP cancel that state at home. And yet people too still there their house, they know they come out to do their business for Oluya with dinner. So if you go watch now, shops they're waiting for this area. Everybody don't close their shop. Shop no open for you. Today will be Monday. And today will be 23rd of August. We'll be say with the experts, say people feel come out due to say this last week Monday sit at home as the year say they cancel this thing. Some people believe say na fake news or the news be not they legit. And today will be the second Monday, the same thing, you know, people not still come out. Meanwhile, the military present for this area they high because they see the patrol to make sure say they ensure say everywhere they come and then people they safe. And we are within a Banana Junction. Banana Junction are the popular place where we say you feel take any motor, they go where you want to go. This side linked to Anambra, and this side they linked to Okigwe. This side also linked to Owerri. And the place where they na no movement, then people will be workers where they work for hospital them. Now then we come work today. So we are within an banana junction for Olo. And with waiting they happen, shops then will expect say, they go open today and then vehicle. They know open today and with waiting they happen and people they believe say the cancellation will be true. So the news be pop out last week where the IPOP and spokesman be talk for radio talk say they don't cancel the sitter too. Can they advise people say may they come out to come do their business because the cancellation come from the highest order from IPOP. Say they cancel them and they don't advise make people for the Southeast may they come out to come do their businesses. So as we did for Olona, this now banana junction and we don't see say business for here, no open shops, they close and no vehicle movement. So we still there for the state as we go they bring on a more update with waiting they happen for here.
This is exactly what is going to happen on Anambra State election. And as a matter of fact, they have declared this themselves. Many people say, oh, IPOB is a Biafrans, they cannot do anything. Let me tell you, since when the people protest, you kill them. Since when people comes out and demand for their right, you destroy them. The people have decided to take law into their hand. And so many of them still believe that exactly what they're doing is given to them by Chukwu Kabiama. Many also still understand and said that it was not Mazen Nnamdi-Kanu. So I am advising the Southeast governors. I am advising those who conjoined in the kidnap of Mazen Nnamdi-Kanu to also meet your Janja with masters and, you know, ask them to release Mazen Nnamdi-Kanu. Ask them to allow Mazen Nnamdi-Kanu to speak. If you people don't allow Mazen Nnamdi-Kanu to speak, it's going to be carry go sit at home. Means it has entered autopilot. All of you know what this is going to result. If every Monday you cannot also force people to go to their house and begin to drug them out, you come, you must go to work, you must go. People don't trust the country. People don't trust the security. Where you can sit your, at your home and you'll be killed by unknown gunmen or by Fulani Janjaweed or by terrorists, you know, who's moving now from Afghanistan to our core, to Nigeria. So who is holding who now on the ground? You know, the IPOP leadership, the DOS, have commanded this sit at home to be canceled. But the people has decided this is how we want it. So why not you people release Mazen Nnamdi-Kanu? Or even give him a fair trial by allowing him to be in an open prison where he can be able to control this monster that you people cannot be able to control. Let me tell you people, they are still believing that Mazen Nnamdi-Kanu is there. He's the one even talking, whether they see or no see. Some didn't believe. But think about the next time that they're coming to court, Mazen Nnamdi-Kanu, they didn't see him in the court. Let me tell you, this is at home order is going to affect the entire Nigeria, anywhere, in fact, the whole South, means the economy of the Zoological Republic is going to be crushed down. This is what all of you have to know. When Mazen Nnamdi-Kanu was rendered, all of you were shouting, hey, we don't get him, you don't catch him. But let me tell you, it's not about catching Mazen Nnamdi-Kanu. It's also to control the things that follows him. It's also to control the monster that he have created. It's also to stop the ideology. He captured Mazen Nnamdi-Kanu, but his ideology is still there. You may be gloating now, yeah, you have catch him now, the IPOB, they are fighting against themselves. No, let me tell you, what you see that are happening in the body of IPOB is because Mazen Nnamdi-Kanu has taught us not to believe on lie. So IPOB must investigate very proper before they believe, even if it be their mama. Biafrans are the good sheep who does not follow the voice of a stranger. In the book of John, chapter 8, I think 8 or 10:44, somewhere there. This is exactly what is happening. But when we misunderstood this scripture about Biafrans and who are saying, no, we must hear from our leader, because Biafrans are the good sheep that followed a good shepherd, which is Mazen Nnamdi-Kanu. They cannot just follow you like that. What you see that are happening right now in IPOB is not because we are fighting against one another. No, it is because we have never heard the voice of our good shepherd, which is Mazin Nnamdi Kanu. So therefore, they cannot even listen to the DOS. They cannot even listen to you, the governors of South, or even the president of Nigeria, if he's there. What is the best thing right now? Is to allow Biafrans to hear the voice of Mazin Nnamdi Kanu if you want to control this monster. People think that we're joking. Even the DOS cannot be able to control this. They must understand, if they at all that they want to control this monster, these people, this sheeps of Mazin Nnamdi Kanu, you cannot use a harsh voice, for they will not even hear you. The moment you want to control them with a harsh voice, they are going to, in fact, they will not even understand you. They will not hear you, because the scripture we read said, the sheep does not understand the voice of a stranger. Even for us, for some of them, the voice of even the DOS is still the voice of a stranger. This is the issue. This is what is going on. But many of you bloggers are there. You know, when you see what is happening, you say, hey, they are fighting together, they are killing themselves. No. Go back to your house and think, why is this Biafrans and IPOBs not even listening to the voice of DOS? So if the Biafran cannot even listen to the voice of the DOS, by going to market when the DOS say go, they don't even want to go. They say, no, we have to sit at home before we are confused. This is not the voice of our leader. Do you think that Nigerian government can be able to control this monster? No, they are creating a very tough situation by even locking down Mazin Nnamdi Kanu, even locking him not to bring him to the court, even stopping Biafrans and killing many Biafrans and holding Mazin Nnamdi Kanu. This will not solve the issue. Let me tell you, you have given us a way on how to take our country by ourselves by holding the leader of the indigenous people of Biafra. This is period what is going on. So the line, like as I said, is open. If you have any decision, if you have something to contribute, it is always, you are free. You are free. This time around is not a time that we should come and say, yeah, DOS and this. No, we have to listen. And DOS also, you have to know that these people have heard the voice of Mazin Nnamdi Kanu. And you know, we Igbo people, you cannot just convince us very easily like that. That's why it is also very difficult for even the DOS to be able to organize these ships. They have heard the voice of the true leader. So it is very difficult for us to believe any other person. This is period. This is exactly what is going on here in Biafra land. This is all this Banana Junction. This Banana Junction, this particular video you are seeing there, is a place that you even Okada people who are walking with their leg, people who are moving. But look at how scanty it is. We are showing you all because we were not able to get the video of other cities. Look at how it's going now. So here you must understand that the monster that those people that kidnap Mazin Nnamdi Kanu is still growing. By holding Mazin Nnamdi Kanu, withholding him, people can't even believe his lawyer. His lawyer can go inside the detention or prison where he is. His brother can go and come out and talk. But let me tell you, if you people does not, if the DSS or the whosoever that holding him, whosoever redeemed Mazin Nnamdi Kanu, does not give him, I could say, free trial and release Mazin Nnamdi Kanu with unconditional release, you are creating another monster that you cannot be able to handle. This is exactly the truth. It has been given to you by prophecy. It has been prophesied and you are seeing it now. Many of you will sit down there thinking that, hey, you are causing war. You can bribe some of our IPOBs. You can even bribe anybody, bribe the DOS, bribe anybody on the corner of Mazin Nnamdi Kanu so that people will come and create war between the IPOBs. It will not solve the problem. The only way to solve this issue and let this problem solve is this, by allowing the people to constantly hearing the voice of their leader, the good shepherd, Mazin Nnamdi Kanu. Failure to do so, everything is going down. No election in Anambra State. Very soon, this seat at home is going to enter Lagos State. Very soon, everybody is going to act the same way, because I think this is the best thing to do. Now the terrorists is ever growing in the southeast and everywhere. Do you know what is happening? We're talking about the holding Mazin Nnamdi Kanu. Don't you know that even some of your governors right now are importing Fulanese, so that when you sit at home, the Fulanese will come and vote for them? They are printing already voters' card, if you don't know. That's why some of the southeast governors are protesting that they don't want the electronic vote. We know what's going on. But now, the Biafrans has taken authority into their hand. They said, we will sit at home or release our leader, our good shepherd, Mazen Nana Kanu, unconditionally, before he can be able to handle these great armies of Mazen Nana Kanu. For God was the one who have given him strength to mobilize this whole army by only speaking truth to them. Because listen, that is a reason why when Jesus was talking about the good shepherd, and the good shepherd is the one who hears the voice of his shepherd, what the people had to follow this Mazen Nana Kanu is the true word he speak. And they know, that's why they call him on Radio Biafra the only incorruptible leader. So that's why. Now, the question of my topic here, the topic that I bring to us here, who now can be able to speak to the people as Mazen Nana Kanu? People don't even believe anybody again. People don't believe anybody. Even the Biafrans and IPOB, they don't even believe that any man can tell them the truth. They will stand as Mazen Nana Kanu used to tell them. Just one word, Mazen Nana Kanu, we speak from that prison. Everywhere we become, you will see people going to market tomorrow. People want to hear the voice of Mazen Nana Kanu. Refusing to hear the voice of Mazen Nana Kanu, the moment you people are withholding Mazen Nana Kanu to speak in that DSS dungeon, is creating a destructive situation that you cannot be able to control. This is good money, no? As I said, lines are open to talk. Biafrans, come here and speak your mind. Come and tell our people. I just give everybody time to come and talk. Now, let's see. People who are jubilating the day Mazen Nana Kanu was indicted, even the former DSS, whatever, was jubilating. They are jubilating. Mazen Nana Kanu has been captured. We thank God for the collaborative effort to rendit Mazen Nana Kanu. Look at, and all of them are the southeast former governors, former DSS, former everything, and the present ones. They are jubilating that Ohamadike was captured. But not about capturing the man, it's about controlling what follows him. Holding Mazen Nana Kanu is like putting a fire on your bed and sleeping on top of the fire. That is exactly what is going on. That is exactly what you are creating. Forget. We, the indigenous people of IPOB, you can sit in your house and you think that we are fighting against each other. No, what you see there is a family issue. It is a family issue that we will resolve it tomorrow. It is, in fact, listen, you know what happened? It happens even in the family of Judah. It happens everywhere. It happens in the different families. Not only an IPOB family, even you that are mocking that IPOBs are fighting, they want to kill themselves. No, it is not. It's not only there. It's happening in every family. All right, it is happening in every family. There are many fights, even in your family right now. You that are hearing my voice, you have issues. The IPOB have issues, and the issue we have is this: that our father who speaks to us is not there any longer. So we want to know where he is. So what the IPOB has taken into consideration that makes them not to open their shop is because they want to hear the voice of the good leader, Mazen Nana Kanu. Because the good shepherd, the sheep can only hear the voice of the good shepherd. And the Bible also tells us that anyone who comes from the window is a thief. So that is the issue you must understand. Biafrans are too wise and they are too intelligent. Many of you who are talking shit, we are killing ourselves. Many of you are mocking us. It's a lie. There is no mockery. We do not have a problem. We are solving our household problem. So many of you, you know, paying them to cause war. No, we are not causing war. They are curious to know where Mazen Nana Kanu is. They are curious that you can never come and feed them. The strangers cannot feed the sheep. All right? This is the main thing. This is the issue here. This is the main issue that are trending. But the people think, yeah, they are killing themselves, you know, causing a lot of people to come to Radio Biafra and talk trash against one another. But the problem will be resolved. Biafra, it has been like this for a long time. Biafrans are willing to reconcile on our problem because we want to hear the voice of our leader, Mazen Nana Kanu. No other stranger can we hear his voice. Mazen Nana Kanu is the leader of the indigenous people of Biafra. It is going to be very difficult for you to control this monster. This is going to the DOS And this is also going to the leaders of the southeast. Holding Mazinan the Kano will cause a lot of damages. The reason why people, when you say the lockdown is over, they didn't believe you, is even they don't believe DOS, how can they believe the South governor? How can they believe Dave Omar, who is ranting that, yeah, if you don't go to your shop, Dave Omar, lock the shop. It is your own problem. Even now, as I'm talking to you, the giant that with your suffer, your master don't even believe who you are, because they have seen who have the power. Even when the DOS or DOS also say, go to the market, they say, no, we cannot go until we hear the voice of our leader. Because the sheep cannot hear the voice of a stranger. They only hear the voice of the good shepherd. That is the chapter that is repeating itself right now in the land of Biafra. You can't control the monster that Mazinan Kano has created. You can't. The more you delay him, problem. In fact, the more they don't hear his voice, the more Nigeria becomes fire. The more fire ignites himself. They will hear, even at a time, the DOS can no longer control this particular IPOB and the Biafras. This is no longer about IPOB registered member. It has gone into autopilot, as Simon has said. Many people will not like it. Let me put like, please. Yes, lady of the light, and the light came. It was the light of God. So these are the issues. These are the issue at hand. Nobody can control this. Now, my question is this: for the time being, who do you think that can control this? That is why I opened my line for us to reason together and talk. So many people come to Radio Biafra, they want to address an issue, they will talk to the people that they are disobedient, that you are this and that. Who are you? Who are that? It will solve the issue. You can yell from here to the other side to control the people who have decided to say, Anna, we are not going to any market, we want to be here. By shouting cannot solve the problem, because they have sensed the truth in Mazinan Kano. And they did not hear from Mazinan Kano that he was the one that spoke to them. Now, I am not blaming the DOS. I am not blaming anybody. I am blaming those who have rendered Mazinan Kano. Who was jubilating that Mazinan Kano has been grabbed, Mazinan Kano has been captured, Mazinan Kano is now into custody. I want to play this man's voice the day Mazinan Kano was rendered, so that you can hear this kind of people. They are the ones that are creating this monster that you see running. These the people, look at his eyes, this man now you see here. There are many of them in the south, in the southeast, that created this monster that makes the people not to believe. These are the people that are paying some people not to allow Mazinan Kano to have his freedom. These are the people that contributed money in order for the rendition of Mazinan Kano. Look at them here. Now, I'm going to play his voice, how he was jubilating, how he was very happy, how he was sacrificing to his shrine because Mazinan Kano was rendered or extraordinary rendition. Look at him. Look at this man now. Look at this. Look at him. Now watch. I want you to listen to this kind of people. There are many. Hidden ones, many. That's why the IPOBs and Biafrans refuse to believe any Igbo man. Even if you are in DOS, until Mazinan Kano speaks. Now, what we'll be looking at now, how can we hear the voice of Mazinan Kano? How can we get the convincing proof that he was the one that spoke? Even his brothers has gone to see him, as they tell us, but the people still not believe that it was Mazinan Kano that spoke. All right? So what we are talking about is, what are we really going to do so that the indigenous people of Biafra will believe that it was Mazinan Kano that spoke to them, if it at all it was him? I am very plain. Biafrans follows Mazinan Kano because of the abundance of the truth that he portrays. Let me tell us, it is very difficult for them to believe any other leader. Somebody said, Maz Austin, need to pin your telephone number. My telephone number is already here. I thought I pinned my telephone number here already. Let me see. I pinned my number here already. Maybe you didn't look at this very proper. For many who want to call in and contribute on what we are going to do, how are we going to convince our people? How can we make them to believe? According to the DOS that say it was Mazen and the Kano, many people have a proof. Many people also who doubt, don't believe, don't even shout at them because they have a reasons for doubting. Believe me, they have a reason for doubting. I thought I pinned my number here today. I thought I have my number. Definitely I pinned my number here. I don't know how it went out. Let me see. I'm going to put it back. Okay. Sorry. Let me put the number back. Right. The number is there already. The number is here. You can take the number. That is WhatsApp number. What am I trying to say? I want to play before you call. Please let us listen to this particular man so that you can know how wicked that the South people, Southeast people are. Listen to this man. If you never watched this video before, watch how happy this man was that Mazen Nnamdi Kanu was in the detail. These are the cause of the problem in the South, the Southeast, because of the kind of hate they have on Mazen Nnamdi Kanu. Who is saying no number? Please can watch, look at the screen there. Some people are still saying no number. Thank you. Please check the number there if you want to call in. Let's play the voice of this particular man.
This arrest is a major one. I almost commend our security agencies, because Nigeria, we must all agree, is drifting to the precipice. Who have a lot of security challenges, and nobody is against Nnamdi Kanu's agitation for Biafra.
Now listen, first of all, he starts by trick. Nobody is against Nnamdi Kanu's agitation, but before he ends his speech, he will become the one, the body that is against Mazen Nnamdi Kanu, everything that he's doing. Now watch, listen very close to this man. These are your problems. This particular man are the problems that you have. All right? These are the problems. This man is the former DSS commander or whatever. Just listen to him very clearly. You will see how wicked men are. You will see how, why the Biafran does not believe anyone who is in authority. Rather, they want to hear the voice of Mazen Nnamdi Kanu. Now listen,
but should be done in a proper manner, not with criminality. He has led a lot of people who have lost their lives innocently with this agitation, and he's
now. Let us ask this man, what is criminality on Mazen Nnamdi Kanu's IPOB Biafran's agitation? What is criminality? Let's ask this man, what is criminality? Criminality is that Mazen Nnamdi Kanu, first of all, before he started his agitation, he said that the Southeast have been marginalized, that the Fulanese cannot only take the power. That is the problem. That is why this man said that Mazen Nnamdi Kanu is a criminal. So since this man started already judging Mazen Nnamdi Kanu already, what do you think? These are your problems. I cannot analyze this very well. That's why I say, join me, come in, and let us talk about these things. Are you getting it now? These are the problems that we have. These are the reason why people, the Biafrans, even when the DOS tell them, go to the market, they say, no, we will not go. When they hear this kind of voice, these are the people that are creating the voice that make our people to disobey every other command. These are the people. This man, he said that Mazen Nnamdi Kanu wouldn't have done it with a criminality. What offense did Mazen Nnamdi Kanu commit? Offense that Mazen Nnamdi Kanu commit, that Mazen Nnamdi Kanu say, no, I will not be alive and see criminals coming to rape our mother. Fulani Janjaweed's coming to rape our mother. But he said, nobody's against Mazen Nnamdi Kanu, but he is the first one that is against Mazen Nnamdi Kanu. Please, the line is here open for anybody who wants to call. I have a caller. Let me take this call, then we'll continue. Call online, your name and where you are. I'll help you after that. Mazu, God bless you.
Yeah. I was speaking to Chukwu Emeka, calling from South Africa.
Thank you, Mazu Chukwu Emeka. Just have 2 minutes to round up, Mazu. We have a lot.
You say?
You have 2 minutes. Right on, sir.
Okay, what I want to say is that, okay, before I make my contribution, that dingo, that dingo, that former DSS animal that is talking now, I actually watched the interview when the Boko Haram, when they set up another government seat in Borno, when they asked him of his opinion, he couldn't even utter a statement.
Thank you.
Understand?
Yes, sir.
He couldn't utter a statement when they asked him about his opinion about the Boko Haram government in Borno. You know, but when it comes to IPOB, you see all of them make noise like idiots. You understand?
Yeah.
So back to my contribution, I am for sit at home. You understand?
Yes, sir.
How can someone explain that for how many months since they kidnapped our leader? In Kenya, we have not heard his voice, not even once. Not even once. And the person they brought to court that faithful day was covered. They covered his face. And somebody is telling us that OPM do say that he should stop sitting at home, that he should continue sitting at home. This is someone that we have not even heard his voice, not even once. You understand? So I am for sit at home, and then for me, the leadership of Pedro doesn't have a lot of tasks, a lot of jobs to do to win back the confidence of most of us, because they are fast losing credibility and control over their fans. So for me, sit at home. Until we are of now, we should suspend the sit at home. For now, we are not sure. They are still telling us, only this. No one will have help from him. So that is my contribution.
Thank you, Mazi Chukwuemeka. Wonderful. You know, you're saying exactly what many people are saying. Thank you, Mazi. Yeah. God bless you. God bless you for a wonderful contribution, you know. So the lines, thank you, Mazi Chike. Very nice contribution. Everybody is doubting each other because of this kind of people. Let's continue listening to him as we wait for other callers. Let's listen to waiting brother, the do brother. Let's listen. What this man
outside the country propagating Biafra. So the main thing for him, I believe, he should come into Nigeria and lead his people so that they...
Is it not what he's doing now? Mazinan, the kind you are expecting to come home and lead his people. Ladies and gentlemen, is our Madike not in their hand? We have not even seen him, but he's leading his people. And the people have determined that the only him that you follow, they will want to follow only Mazinan, the Kano. Now you say that he should come home. He's there. Is Mazinan not there? He has never even opened his mouth. These are the people that are contributing money, suppressing Mazinan Kano to talk. Somebody said that they will not stop going to the market because of this kind of people who are paying some money to people to suppress, to oppress Mazinan Kano. These are the people that contributed money for the rendition of Ahamadike. Are you getting it now? These are the people that are spoiling the country. These are the people that when Biafrans look at it, they say, no, since when we come outside, you shoot us, let's enter into our houses or the calamities are over, according to the book of Isaiah. All right. So let's listen to this man fluently. I want you to take your pen and paper and listen to this kind of human beings that they call some of your leaders and the elites of Igbo land, or I would say South or Southeast. The line is open as we are listening.
We follow him, but not outside that people are losing their lives. I abhor criminality. That's the most important thing, because even though it must be noted too that Nnamdi Kanu has said that they are not responsible for the killings in the East, but we should have a right to life, you know, sanctity to life. People are being beheaded. He opened this.
Let's ask this man, who are the killers? Let's ask this kind of leaders you have in Igbo land that to cause the people not to believe that the Mazinan Kano has spoken about lifting up the or canceling the sit at home. These are the problem that you have. These are the consequences of the every evil. Where was this man when Fulani henchmen are raping old women and little children in the South, in the Southeast? Now let's ask this man, who this former DSS whatever, let's ask him, what was Sunday Boho fight? What was Sunday Boho's agitation? Let's ask this particular man now who is jubilating that Mazenana Khan has been rendered. Let me tell us something. These are the people that is your problem. Many of them have been bought by Fulanese. These are the people. I just want to play this video today. I could say this movie so that you can hear this kind of people. He said that many people are losing their life. How many people has Fulanese killed? How many people that the police, the SARS killed? There was a trending now that the one IPOB lady was kidnapped by the police, and this lady are still under the custody of the police, and they are Hannah Adrowa, the girl in India, and this girl, his family has gone and find out what they did, the transfer. These are the problem that you have. These people are the problem that you have. Now let's listen to his nonsense talks. They will continue.
Mouth, he calls Nigeria a zoo, and he said he has placed a 100 million naira bounty on a sitting governor. These are reckless statements. And I believe that the law should take its course.
Have you seen it? So the law should take its course. How many times have you seen this man come out on a channel TV or BBC, whether Igbo or Yoruba or Broken, and talk about the killings that are going on by the Fulani Janjaweeds? How many times have you seen this kind of people come out and tell the world how the terrorists, the Mietiala government, are killing our people? Rather, he decided to deny the whole fact and only see Mazenana Khan, because Mazenana Khan is the only one who is bombarding them with the truth. Have you seen why the people refuse to follow any other person, only Mazenana Khan? This is the consequences of everything that is happening right now. Do not blame the people who say, no, we must sit at home until we hear from Mazenana Khan. These are the things. So we should not stop fighting one another. When the people hear this kind of voices, they will say, no, we don't trust these people. We know how wicked they are. We must make sure that we hear the voice of Mazenana Khan, because they are into the hand of a very bad Janjaweed Fulani caliphate in the Igbo nation. A country where you will evict those who are victim, immediately you talk about how you are a victim of kidnapping, you become extraordinary victim, they will kill you. These are the people, these are the ones who create it. Now tell me, as a DSS commander before, what do you know how many people this man has put into prison and killed for nothing? Since this man can look at Mazenana Khan and say that Mazenana Khan is a criminal and have killed people. Now look at it. And now he's giving credit to those who are killers. Who are the Fulani Janjaweed? The Fulani Janjaweed as one the most second terrorist organization in the face of this world. But this man cannot open his mouth because of power and his stomach. Now he's blaming Mazenana Khan. Dear friends, these are the reason why people don't believe anybody any longer. All right? These are the reason why people don't believe anybody. These are the reason when Biafran don't believe on even me, don't blame them. They have reason not to believe that Mazenana Khan is the one who said, go and your business, rather for sit at home. When the masses, when Biafran's in the market, when everybody look and they hear the kind of all these people, the voice of all these kind of people, they say, no, we can never give up. These are evil. These are DSS that are holding our leader. They don't believe that anything can come out of them. The lines are open for anyone who want to call. Please, dear friend, this is a time that we rub minds together. This is a time for us to talk together, not about fighting one another. We're talking about the people that created the monsters that are eating us up. These are the people that brought confusion in Olu. They say people refuse to go out in Olu. Let's watch it again. People refuse to go out.
So we just will come the main park this morning, Sean, how the situation be regarding compliance or otherwise. Now, right now, I did for the main park. This is Naba main park, and just as you see, you know, from this end, everywhere they deserted. It's like people almost a ghost town this morning. Right now at 9:30 today, like this will be Monday. We say we can't give our first hand information how matters be for this place this morning. And if you look just around me here, you go see everywhere they deserted. Like activities here, they very you know scanty. On a normal day here now. Activities upon activities you go to see here. You go see people they sell clothes, people they buy things, transportation businesses, transmission companies, they you know do the activities on a particular Monday like this. You will see say a lot of things you know what they happen for you. But then so far so good this morning.
If we have to convince our people, this message for the DOS, I don't say you people are not doing good. Yes, we have fought against each other. But let's also look to the cause of the problems. Why people don't believe anybody any longer? Why must we believe each other? Even those of us who are also hotel members. I have a call on the line. Call out your name and where you are. God bless you.
Good evening, Mazi. This is calling from Bola.
Mazi Chemezie, welcome. Great comrade.
Thank you, my brother. You are doing a very good job.
Thank you.
I have been enjoying your program, the way you are putting everything in the right way.
Thank you.
Yes, I so much like the angle you are taking our people to, because it looks like since we are all IPOB, it looks like we don't like to talk about things that is going wrong.
Thank you.
So I always like that you normally touch there whenever you are doing your program. So let me contribute to your program today.
Right on, man.
You know, what we have to know about Nigeria is that Nigeria breeds criminality. You know?
For sure.
Nigeria breeds criminality.
For sure.
And that is a very big problem. So like this man that is talking now, you know, why did they bring him out? He's our own brother. So they have to bring him out to condemn his brother.
Thank you.
And because of the system of the country, all of them are corrupt. You know, anybody that works in Nigeria is corrupt. Without corruption, you can't survive in Nigeria. So what do? Anytime they are brought out to talk, you know, we see that because of their own fire,
mm-hmm.
they will always talk against their people. So when we talk about the sit at home, our people are very smart people, and that we have to understand. Our people are very smart people. They see through all these things.
Mm-hmm.
And now, you know, for our minds, we need to be able to convince their friends. You know, it's not a day job.
It's not a day job.
it's something that have taken many years. You know, even when people were going against him. A lot of people were going against him. A lot of people sabotaged him, but because he was steadfast, he was somebody that speaks the truth. And you know, no matter how you dance around, truth will always stand.
For sure.
You know, and with time, people start to see that quality in him, and people start to believe in him. Leadership, you know, you make people to believe in you by the things you do.
Absolutely.
You know, it's not about making noise, you know, or causing people. It's the things you do. That is where you know people. And Mazi Nnamdi Kanu have shown that. And that is why people are fighting for him.
Yes.
You know, for one man to ground the whole eastern part of that country, it's not the governors, they should come together and sit down and listen to this man.
Yes.
How do we put things right?
Yes.
With somebody that commands the youth like this. Because the youth, they are the future of the country we are fighting for.
Yes.
So the government should do something about that and try to do it quick, because things will soon get out of hand, and it will be very difficult to control.
Exactly.
So yes, you know, another thing I want to talk about, because since we are forgetting, we don't need to forget how this country illegally kidnapped our leader.
Yes, sir.
You know, their plan from the beginning was to kill Mazi Nnamdi Kanu.
Mm-hmm.
That is That is what they planned, you know. So when they were told to come and take Mazen Nnamdi Kanu, it was a surprise to them because this is not what they bargained for. But because Elohim still has so much work to complete through this man.
Yes, sir.
And that was why they couldn't kill Mazen Nnamdi Kanu.
Yes.
Nobody can destroy him.
Nobody can kill him.
People should understand that you don't have somebody like this. You only have somebody like this once in your lifetime. You just like footballers. You have Messi once in your lifetime. You have Peter Ronaldo once in your lifetime. You have Jesus Christ once in your lifetime.
Exactly.
You have Mazen Nnamdi Kanu once in your lifetime. It doesn't come easily. Somebody like this, when we lose him, then we understand what we have given away.
Correct.
You understand?
Correct.
So when God protected this man and Nigerian government brought him to Nigeria, Nigeria was ashamed to even show his face to the world.
Mm-hmm.
They had to cover his face in the courts. So my question is, why are they covering Mazen Nnamdi Kanu's face?
These are the pain. Mazi, thank you. These are the reason why some of the Biafrans that are passionate, they said no. Although the DOS can be making a lot of sense, it can also be Mazi that has spoken that to cancel the seat at home. But Biafrans are so passionate, and they know that Mazi Nnamdi Kanu, doesn't retreat from his word. I'm going to play a video here where Mazi Nnamdi Kanu interview. Now, the question is this, now I also want to throw to you. So, who do you think that we can meet or who can talk to the Biafrans to convince them about going to the market?
I think it's a very good question, but I think for the fact that Mazen Nnamdi Kanu is in the enemy's camp, even if he talks to them, what we need is freedom. You cannot be in captivity and be able to give others that will favor the same cause you are fighting for.
Thank you.
Do you understand?
Yes.
Any order that comes from where they are holding him, will always be to favor our enemies. That we have to know. It doesn't matter whether Mazen Nnamdi Kanu come out today now and say, okay, the African people, let's go home, this, that, but our people will still say no. We are right it down.
Exactly.
Because they know that once he was free, there must be something that they are telling him for him to come out and say this.
Yes.
You understand? So that is what we have to know. What we need is unconditional release of Mazen Nnamdi Kanu. Then he will come outside and then address Biafra on his own. Nobody should put him under duress to address Biafra. You understand?
Mm-hmm.
And that is what will stop all these things. I'm telling you, see these Biafra people, you know how many millions that have died for this thing? We have been fighting for our freedom for how many years now? So this is not a joke. What you are seeing now is something. This thing was done in India. It was practiced in India that before you knew it, the British people ran away from India. They will come to the office, they will not see anybody to admit to talk to.
Of
course. For so many moves, British government had to leave India for them after much and much.
On point, you know, yeah.
So the last thing I want to talk about also before I will leave, because people will be calling.
Yes.
You know, this is our old statement. I want to say something about it. Maybe you can say something about it also.
All right.
You know, this is our own taking. You know, we have to understand that. The freedom of our people. I'm not only passionate about the freedom of our people. I'm passionate because of my heart first. You have to have the heart, a good heart, for you to fight for freedom.
On point.
You understand?
Yes, sir.
So people should understand that most of our people are very good people. And that is why they don't want our people to be suffering. You understand?
Exactly.
Our people in general are good people. Why am I saying this? Let us not use this cult of a thing to take our people away in this trouble. Because there are people that doesn't like when they hear oath, they think it's a spiritual, you are taking them to shrine, whatever they are doing is a very bad thing that will come after them. But they don't know that we are doing this to make sure you are committed.
Yes.
So there are people that don't need proof. They don't need
But let me so shoot. Mazi, let me put my mouth on this aspect of your contribution. You know, our people are always thinking it to be kind of, like you said, going to shrine. They first of all see the dangers ahead of it, but they don't see the betrayer that can betray tomorrow. So now let's ask ourselves, what brought the oath taking? What brought the oath taking is people like this particular man now, you see, that is against his own people. Oath, you know, according to Paul in the Bible, Paul say it was sin that led us to know what is evil. Are you getting it now? It is because of the betrayal of one another. That is why the oath taking becomes imperative. How do you say it in the Biafran agitation? There are many people, even coordinators here, who are printing their own invoice to collect money from people. Are you getting it? So, and we should be talking about which kind of oath that we have to, I could say, impose in IPOB that can be very effective. Mas, you know, this oath we're taking, people think it's coca oath, they're taking it and tomorrow they will still go and commit offense. So oath taking is just the same thing that you find a job tomorrow. You must sign a contract. It is also an oath. These are the oath taking.
Yeah.
So that you cannot be able to betray people. Thank you.
Okay. It's not a problem. I can't hear you anymore.
Can you hear me now?
Okay, I can hear you now.
All right, yes, I'm here.
Okay, this whole thing, why I want to round up there is that there are people that are not committed like us.
Mm-hmm.
You understand?
Yes.
But they love what we are doing. They support us. There are people that contribute money, even in order than where we are. There are people that will come to our meeting. They say they don't want to take food. They just want to be contributing. They like what we are doing. Mm. You understand?
Yeah.
They want to be supporting us. They want to be contributing money. They say, okay, you can contribute money, but you will not be here and follow the meeting. Do you understand?
Mm.
They will do that and leave. Do you know that most, the same people that are donating to this our struggle, do you know they are not food takers? Are you aware?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, yes, I know.
Big money that comes into this struggle, yeah, most of them they are not good takers. So what I'm saying is that let us try to allow people, let's get the Biafra first.
Mm.
When you look at where is Chemoko today, where is Omiomio today? These are the people they took oath. Where are they?
Yeah, you know, Maz, I will tell you something. I understand what you're saying, like for coming to the issue of let me just mention it, like our brother Simon Epa that have been trending, you know. Many people, I saw, like if I put a reference from what you are saying, he's doing a great job. But people still say that he must take an oath, but that is between him and Mazi Nandekala. And to be honest with you, Mazi Simon Epa has taken an oath. But the oath he took is not in Finland family. I look at him on his program that I asked him. I told that he can take an oath. There was a time in Amsterdam here when I started broadcasting newly. They said, no, I have to take an oath, but I'm already an oath member, you know, in another group of IPOB. The same book, the same oath we took. But when the IPOB, they called me, they said, no, I have to come and take the oath. Then I will continue. I fought against it. I called a lot of people. They also advised me to take an oath. So me also, I'm advising our brother Simon Epa to take an oath. You know, I'm advising him to take an oath so that taking an oath is a call into his office. Okay. So I think, Amata, you hear me, you cannot go to a job and you want to receive a good salary without signing a contract on that particular company. So it is not allowed. So the oath taking is our mood of operation, let me say, how do you say it in English? So it is necessary. Thank you, Mazi.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, for other people to
come. Don't forget, that God works in a mysterious way.
Yes,
Your voice is gone. God works in a mysterious way. Let's say now, you see our DOS, and I don't want to be talking them about, I don't want to be bringing them, but sometimes you have to refer to them.
Yes.
Your voice is gone.
I'm hearing you clear.
Okay, like our brother Simon Epa is doing a very good job. Assuming Simon Epa now is with DOS. Are you following me?
I'm hearing you, Mazi.
assuming Temoneba is with the group of DOS now, do you know that there will be no other counter person now in this our struggle? So let's allow God to do things the way God is working.
Yes, that is also true.
Temoneba has his own broadcast channel that is doing well. Is it, when you are listening to Temoneba, you don't hear noise. Everything is very clear. When I'm listening to DOS these days, everywhere is noisy. Background is noisy. Since our mother left that station, things are very noisy there. They need to work on it. You understand?
Yes.
They need to get themselves also organized. You know?
Mm-hmm.
But when you follow my Simon Epa now, you listen to his broadcast. No noise, my brother. No noise. Let me not forget that. You see, our Lego team, they need to find out why they refuse our Mazi, they refuse him doctor from outside. I am suspecting something. When Nigerian government kidnapped our leader, it is possible that they have injected something in our leader, his body. And
yes,
they are taking this time for that thing to be able to go out from his system. And that is why they don't want...
Those are the things. Thank you, Mazi. Let's round up.
They are giving time for all these things to go out.
Yes.
So I will stop here so that other people can.
Yes, you know. Let me ship something for what you said before you go. You know, as far as the zoo is concerned, we don't trust them. You know, the zoo can do anything.
Yes.
So I have already thought about the DOS and also our legal practitioners to begin to invoke the issue of bringing a legal advisor from outside, you know. So, and this is also the reason why this is the issue that motivates, I could say, some of our brothers back home that said, no, we're not going to our shop until we hear from our leader and we want him to be released. So DOS also must understand that these are the reason why that that caused the people to take law into their hands. So I think your suggestion and your advice is very clear. So Mazi, thank you, and let's see if another person will call. Thank you for calling to this program. I think you are the only Netherlands person that always call in here on this platform. God bless you.
thank you. You are doing a good job. Thank you.
Thank you, Mazi. I appreciate you. Thank you so much. God bless you. Yeah. Wonderful. This man, only Netherlands person where they call. Other people, they see it for granted. Mazi come call. All right, so I think I'm having another caller that is calling, so we move.
It deserted. It's we like move. Almost a ghost town this morning. Right now at 9:30, today like this will be Monday. We say we can't give on our first-hand information how matters be for this place this morning. And if you look just
everywhere
around,
dry.
You see everywhere they deserted. Like activities here, they very
lines are open
scanty.
For suggestion.
On a normal day here now,
we move
activities upon activities. You go to see here, you go see people they sell clothes.
That is the reason why things, people took the
transportation
law
businesses,
their hand.
Transportation companies, they. You know, do the activities on a particular Monday like this. You will see say a lot of things. You know what they have
really want to change.
So far,
things.
So good this morning. Nobody can.
They must be able to bring somebody, people who know how to put love to talk to them. If it is necessary that we have to really stop this shit at home, people have decided and they are not going to stop it. Now, 2 weeks, they are still believing on what they believe. People say no, they're not going to go back from this sit-at-home order. If you come to Radio Biafra, or if I come to this platform, and if you come to your Facebook or your platform, you begin to holler to the people that is abundant, they are this and that, people will not listen to you. They will see you also like the zoo people who are aggressive, all right? Like the man I was playing his video here. They are the same people. So we need people who will talk to our people gently, who can convince people. Let me tell you, if I say people like Simon Epa, people will say, hey, yeah, because Simon Epa is not a dead person, you are bringing him. But this man has the charisma of talking to people to change their mind. That's why 95% of us is following that man called Simon Epa. It is not something to fight about. I made a program, somebody said my number. Why people don't go to the comments and they even look for where I put the number to call in Mazi? There was a person that was saying my number. I thought I pinned my number here. People don't see the number I pinned here. Oh, wonderful. Too much comments, that's why. Let me see if I can get the number for people to call, somebody call. So what we must understand is IPOB, they are very sensitive. Like as I said in the beginning, there are ships that doesn't hear the voice of a stranger, and they have a reason to say we are not going to shop. People, you can call, you can talk about it on your platform and say, yeah, they are disobedient, they are this and they are that. And the more you persuade the people and to tell them that they are disobedient, the more disobedient they become. And also, you create the enmity between them. So you must know how to talk to the people anywhere you are, from Radio Biafra, and don't divert the people to believe in you because you're the only one who knows how to talk. People know are sensitive to people who can talk to them with respect. Like now, if I come online here because I have a platform, Mazo Kongo, and I begin to talk to my people, I talk to people anyhow. So let me pin the number again. I don't know why people don't see this number. Is it because of what? The line is there. The number is there. Please, this line, you can now take the number and the call in if you do. And before then, the number is here. This is WhatsApp number if you want to call in for the WhatsApp and contribute. It is WhatsApp. Before this, I will continue playing the voice of this particular man that I played before. Then after that, I'm going to play an interview with our leader somewhere on the TV, one of the TV broadcasters, I would say, journalists. Then we can now, let me bring this man up again. Now,
I wasn't actually expecting that he was going to be arrested, but I know that international collaboration, if Nigeria collaborates with the Interpol and our own security agency, they work with the NIA.
This is not a collaboration, because if you say collaboration, there are many people, he's a DSS, he have worked in the office of DSS, but he doesn't know what is collaboration. To rendit somebody, official rendition, he's talking about collaboration in kidnapping somebody. So as a DSS former officer, he's talking about kidnap. Mazi Nnamdi was kidnapped, and he said he knew if collaboration. This is not, even if I am him as an official person who know what the law is, he shouldn't have even come here to show face that Mazi Nnamdi was, they have to collaborate before. They collaborated to rendition him. They collaborated to kidnap Mazi Nnamdi. That's what we're talking about here. I have a call on the line before I continue. Call online, your name and where you are. God bless you.
Yeah, my name is Mazi Lucky Okechukwu Biafra.
Mazi.
Mr. Austin Okonkwo.
Thank you, Mazi.
Well done for your good job.
Thank you, Mazi.
Fascinating.
God bless you.
Yeah. What I want to say is very simple. Everybody can see what is going on in the land of Biafra.
Thank you.
No matter how they decided to paint it, or how they decided to say to Biafrans that the seat at home is cancelled. You can see it today in the land of Biafra. You can see it today that even the current video that is trending in social media, where the chief is speaking about Biafra. What I want viewers to understand is that normally I always like to use a good people parable, like Samuel Ackman. He said that the Biafra agitation, you know, is now in autopilot. And a lot of people, they don't understand what Mr. Samuel Ackman means. So what I want to say is that as we are fighting for this struggle, also people back home, they need the freedom more than people in Western world.
Correct.
You can see today everywhere was shut down in different states in the land of Biafra. So, I don't know how the U.S. will do it. I don't know how they will come out now to tell Biafra, okay, let's just continue this sit-at-home order, because you can see the hierarchy in the world that Biafra, they love freedom. And Biafra,
clearly, the whole world is hearing you, sir.
Okay. Then no, you know, you got to love who love you. Anybody that love you, anybody that cares about you, you need to care about that person also. Because Biafra doesn't have the kind of love there. He cares about them and about our children are born. So yes. They are not crying.
Mm-hmm.
When you see people coming out to, you know, in the media to say, oh, you want to spread the economy of East Africa in the land of Biafra. These people were paid by Fulani Janja with terrorist government. I call them Republic of ISIS, Boko Haram, Al-Qaeda Republic. Not Biafra. Biafra was not complaining. Biafra citizens don't complain.
Yes, sir.
But those people that the zoo have given money through the Eastern governor, through this useless man from Anambra State who is campaigning as a governor,
Mm-hmm.
Those are the people complaining. And the end of the day now, what are we saying? What can the other say to Biafra now? Because for me, I believe the other did not make a mistake in one side. In the other side, if you check it, they make a big mistake.
Exactly.
Because everybody knows, even the blind know that this sit at home is driving the Fulani Janja whistle in the land of Biafra.
Exactly.
It's making them going crazy that they are the government in charge, right?
Mm-hmm.
But IPOB, under the leadership of Mahasinman, the Kanwan Shireke, Oyagadere Man Ototo, the Iye Nabani,
he said,
that is the one in charge. So, you see today, it's not by propaganda, because some people will not go, it's past video, it's past picture, they edited, you know, because these two media, they are good in propaganda. They always believe that everything is edited, everything is doctored, you know, but they can see today, even the BBC also went to the town today. Then when they see that everywhere is locked down, everywhere is shut down.
Of course, it's dry.
That is what Biafra wants. Because people back home, every one of them, if they are being video, that this sit at home, they are not complaining. For those people in abroad who would think they are with us, whereby we don't know they are their enemies. They are the enemies that Mazin and the Kanu say, the worst enemy in life is the enemy within your household.
Correct.
The worst enemy is the enemy within your kindred or your village. Some of the evildoers, I said it, Lucky Okechukwu Biafra said it, the Asuru Basuro Biafra man, they are inside IPOB, us in the company, they are the ones giving the information to the full and the other way.
That is true, Mazi.
Every activity, every program of IPOB. But the other thing that Mahazin and the Kano, Moses of Mapai, often I can't see for Gaba Honor.
Yes, sir.
I can't see for Gaba Honor. What about Gaba Honor? Etero 1, Etero 2. The Afros in this lockdown. That Kami the Yaba Omis.
Exactly.
That is where they stand.
Yes.
So let you forget about anything. Even though the order comes from our leader, Mazin Nnamdi Kanu, let them also go back and tell Mazin Nnamdi Kanu brother or Barista, if I say your four, nice man, nice attorney, let them tell that the average said no, that this lockdown is the only weapon they have to destroy the zoo, finally, because zoo has already been destroyed. To let the international community know that we have governors, we have senators, minor senator Abaribe, the father of the other, a bunch of blood-sucking demon politicians. So their deaths are over. Their game is up. So let them set to the DOS give the information to Balitivari Jephoda. Biafra say that this is the only chance, this is the only sacrifice they had to make for you, for you to be released.
Exactly.
Because that is the only weapon that Fulani understand. This sit at home is getting there in their brain.
Correct.
It's getting there in their brain. They are getting it hurt by this sit at home.
Mm-hmm.
You can see all the Lion One interview. Eh? So, this is the other weapon we have. How they do it, if it's from by the center is your fault, nobody knows. But without Mazin Mandikano, the land of Biafra will be conquered by man.
Exactly.
Nobody will be speaking evil, nobody will be answering Musa, answering Samuel, answering Arija. So Biafra said that this is the only thing they have to give to this man. And that is the weapon that we have. I call it the weapon of atomic bomb. That is the only weapon Fulani understand now.
Thank you.
So they can go to hell with the Eastern governor, like the useless soul who's of India, who they impose on Imo citizens, who say that he is the one giving a chance to repentant Boko Haram and repentant by bandits and ISIS to come to the land of Biafra, to bomb Biafra. So let them know that they put them as the governor, for they are in charge. They are Biafrans, are in charge. They are Amazin Mandikano, no matter what happened, Amazin Mandikano is in charge.
Thank
all the disciples, all the good disciples of Amazin Mandikano is in charge.
Thank you, Mazin.
Because inside disciples, let me finish.
All right.
Inside disciples of Amazin Mandikano,
Maz, I want to ask you a question. Thank you. Can I ask you one question, sir? Can you hear me?
Yeah,
on this situation now, I just want you to pause. Can you watch a video?
Yeah.
I want to show you a video that I played before. Maybe you're not online with me. Just stay there, let me play this video. And then we can watch it.
Yeah. After Bishop's conference in Owerri,
they
resolved that IPOB should suspend the every Monday exercise, owing to at least that it's biting hard on the economy of the Southeast. They now resolved that any day that Nnamdi will be coming to court, the sit-at will be affected. But unfortunately, people are not, don't have that confidence to come out. Auditing is responsible.
The problem is that the people that are resolving that IPOB should mire everything and people should come out, I believe they are in order by saying that the whole thing will be done like that. But there's something they forgot. People is already fearing. This is number one. And number two, people believe that Nnamdi Kanu is in DSS custody. Then number three, they should allow Nnamdi Kanu to speak from DS custody.
Mazu, have you heard that? I stand with this man. So do you stand with him?
Yes, I cannot watch the video because when I'm calling you, I have to log out from the other.
Yeah, but
the one that's watching you.
Did you hear him?
Listen to the comment of that man.
Thank you.
That is the best option. The Biafrans, disciples of Mazin and the Kano, let's call ourselves disciples, the FPOB family and Biafrans in general, want to hear the voice of Mazin Mandikano, even though it's not video, because every episode of Mazin Mandikano, the video that Mazin Mandikano does, so they can never concoct any doctor video to come and play to us or use another person's voice. If it's probably, let them use video, let the other see, let it be live. The Mazin Mandikano want to speak to Biafra. Because if Fulani is getting it hot by this lockdown, if we continue this lockdown, Fulani, Boko Haram government, they have no other choice. This Sheikh Gumi and the Pantanese terrorist government, they have no other choice than to suck it. Let Mazin Mandikano out, put him on video even though it's a useless and imbecile channel TV terrorist platform, let Mazina Dikano speak to Biafra. Because if you come out to say, Mazina Dikano say that you suspend the lockdown,
yeah,
as a club. For me, 100%, I'm not saying 99.9, I'm saying 100%, I'm not with that kind of suggestion.
Thank you, Mazi.
I'm not with it.
Thank you.
Yeah, because the thing is that sometimes things don't happen, things happen to open people's eyes, you know? Because if you consider lockdown, that already Fulani, they are like wounded lions. They are complaining. That why? And the eastern region, the Fulani have governors. Why is it that after they have you know, these enemies of Biafra? Because people that are so mad as in the Kano, they know their self.
Of course.
Yeah, they know their self. They are also, you know, when you call yourself disciples, for example, our Master Jesus.
Master, I want you to round up. Yes.
Yes.
Thank you.
So, who gives information to the zoo government of every IPOB activity?
Yes.
They are just that. That is their work. They earn monthly salary from the hands of the Jagaway terrorist government called Zoological Republic Nigeria. But they will be coming out of club they have IPOB. Through their IPOB, they are under oath. But the fact is, that oath they take, nobody forced you to take it.
Thank you.
Nobody imposed that oath on you that is compulsory. You are the one that make up your mind. This oath will haunt you and your generation down. Because a lot of people don't know the meaning of that oath. You can call it ordinary paper that you say you agree, nothing. When that thing starts happening to you and your family, you will be looking outside. What is the problem?
Oh, right.
My enemies are around the corner.
Okay.
The enemy is not at work. The innocent son, who are applying for this Biafra struggle, they are the ones in charge.
Thank you, Mazi. Thank you for your contribution. So
we
move forward. Thank you, Mazi. Thank you.
Continue your good work.
Amen.
I just love what Biafrans are doing when I come in the land of Biafra. You are supposed to come there and bless each and every one of them.
You said?
Biafra.
Thank you.
All right, Biafra.
Thank you, Mazaloki.
Yeah.
Wonderful. Thank you.
Yeah.
It was a nice contribution. We must continue. Nobody, no use all. But what I told Biafrans is that the Biafrans, those of us who are at home that refuse to say that they should sit at home, as I put it before, Biafrans are too sensitive. They have listened to the voice of Mazi Nnamdi Kanu, and they know that Mazi Nnamdi Kanu is the good shepherd, like the Bible said. That's why I put it before. They were like, we cannot listen to any other voice except the voice of the good shepherd. So it is very difficult to convince them not to listen to the voice of truth. Now we have to ask ourselves, how did Mazi Nnamdi Kanu were able to convince this great army? Even when he was not there, even when he sent somebody, the person cannot believe that it was Mazi Nnamdi Kanu that sent him. So because of the truth that he has convinced the people with. Before I bring Bishop, let's pick this call. Caller online, your name and where you are. Mazin.
Hello.
Good evening, Mazin.
Good evening, can you hear me?
Caller, I'm hearing you clearly. The whole world is hearing you. Speak up.
Okay, all right. My name is Dozier. I'm calling from Biafra land.
Thank you, Dozier. How was it today?
It was awesome. The whole place was totally locked down.
So
nobody, we didn't go to anywhere. We were playing football.
Okay, now why do you people decide? Does it thank you? You come from the happening place. Why do you people decide to force the sit at home order? Why the DOS have said that everybody should return to the markets? So, what is your take on that?
We didn't force the sit at home order. We did it out of our own love, out of our own solidarity to our leader, because they said Asmani Badi was, but in terms of our leader, Oyendu, our supreme leader, Mazen Nnamdi Kanu, in the world, both adults, both little children, both young and old, knows who Mazen Nnamdi Kanu is. I will respect him, I will love him so much. So that is why we decided to forfeit Monday's as his own day for the release of our leader, and which we know that this situation is hitting the Fulani Janja route very, very well. They are finding it very, 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 very hot. That is why they are doing everything just to convince some of the saboteurs in order to stop us from what we are doing. But this situation is a spiritual thing, because Chukwuka Kabiama is with us. Because it's not ordinary. Because some people will be seeing it as an ordinary thing, but it's not ordinary. But to us, this is spiritually.
Uh-huh.
And we are putting it up, and we are observing it. Every Monday we continue to be a situation for us. We are in Biafra.
Thank you.
Without any means of protest, and this is our own way of showing our leader that we truly love him and we are missing him.
Mm-hmm.
And we are just praying for Chukwuka to bring him back to us, life, well, and healthy. So that we'll be able to see him again, we'll be able to talk to us again. Because our mothers are crying, our fathers are crying.
Okay.
Just to hear the voice of our leader.
Dozier, I want to ask you one question before you go to your own contribution. Because, you know, I'm happy you are calling from the happening ground where nobody should tell you what is happening. We are from another planet. So now, let me ask you, what is your take? Do you believe that it was Mazen Nnamdi Kanu that told the DOS to stop this, as you see it from the ground? To stop this, what can you say?
To me, I don't believe them 100%. Why I say so is this: from all sense, when this situation was about to kickstart, the DOS was emphasizing on it very, very well. Even before the first situation, when our leader's brother came out and said that it has been suspended. We remember that Chinan Sahol, he came up and was against it. He said all manner of things against Kanuta. He was insisting that Chinan Sahol will continue for as long as Nnamdi Kanu is in detention. That the only way Sitatong will be suspended is when our leader is out from the prison. And which our leader is not out from the prison, and if people are coming out to tell us that Sitatong might be suspended, what is the alternative? There is no alternative. If you are not saying that Sitatong has been suspended, that we should wait. Any day we are hearing a court case, that is when we have Sitatong, which is not normal. We are not taking it. Because we saw the first sit at home, it was remarkable. It was 100%, 110% successful. So why, and we the followers of Nnamdi Kanu, we know who our leader is. Our leader cannot see something that is successful and going to bring a change to wherever he is. And just come up and say, yes, I'm suspending this sit at home without any community reason. So we don't agree with what TFL says, because right now we've taken a decision on our own to tomorrow to Tatum on Monday.
So you believe in the autopilot?
The zoo dungeon. Yes, we are an autopilot according to our brother Samuel Epa.
Thank you, Dozier. Thank you. Oh yeah, you can make your comment. You have one more minute to go so that I can bring Bishop in. All right.
Okay, I want to ask from what I heard from Simon Ekpa, he said before he granted our Supreme Leader interview that he has taken his oath through somebody, is it Madam Adama or somebody like that? That he has taken his oath. So I'm asking, is the oath taking a plain thing that someone will take oath two times? The first one he took, is it different from this one they are asking him to go and take it? And from what I saw in his Facebook of just 5 minutes ago, he said he has taken oath.
Yes, I want to explain that issue. You know, IPOB, like in the Netherlands where I am, where you take an oath, and when you miss meeting, let me start from here. When you miss the meeting about two times, you come back. You must re-oath yourself. This is the format, how it is run. And anywhere you reside, if you are in Gabon, as long as you are in another country, you have to register yourself to the family where you are, and they take the oath. It can be, if maybe Mazen Nandekano and Simon have a different kind of oath, because you know those of the people that are into a deep relationship with Mazen Nandekano also have a different kind of oath that we ourselves don't even know. Are you believing me now? So Simon Ekpa can be an oathed member of IPOB. There was a time I joined IPOB, I was an oath member. The family in the Netherlands, they has to ask me to come and take a oath. So what it simply means is, it is a call to your office. So it is a call to your office. You must always do that. So thank you. That's the answer to that. So, but I think I am also telling Mazi Simon Epa, if they want him to take an oath is not a hot cooker oath. You can go there and take oath. It's not a problem. You know, but if he also does not want to take an oath, he can stand and do his job that he's doing, as long as he's doing the job good. Let me come. There was a time the disciples of John was baptizing. The disciples of Jesus was baptizing. They are doing the baptism for the kingdom of God, wasn't it?
Yes.
At the time, they started meeting themselves. This one said, hey, master, we saw some people who are baptizing. They're doing exactly what we're doing. So the disciples of John went to gossip about John about what Jesus was doing. No, about the disciples of Jesus went to gossip to Jesus what the disciples of John was doing. He asked them, on whose name are they baptizing? Have you seen it? Simon Epa is baptizing on the name of Mazen Nandekano. IPOB are baptizing on the name of the same Mazen Nandekano in order to approach the kingdom of Biafra. So all of us, we are the same people. So that's why I say, but if you come to the family of IPOB, the oath taking is our way of life. So he must take an oath. If he has never come to the family in the Finland, he's my man. I love him. Nobody should play with Simon Epa, but I'm telling you how it is run. He'll be hearing my voice. I told him also in his platform that he have to take an oath. So thank you, Mazen.
Okay, sorry. I just want to advise the POS, because they are at this critical moment. They are the head of the affairs, since our leader is not around, they should just have to do everything possible to unite everyone together. Because at this critical time, we don't see we in Biafra land, we are finding it very difficult, because We can't be going out because we are afraid of the zoo army and all. But we are not saying we are here we are. So they have to do everything and unite everybody. So everybody will have one voice. If somebody is coming out to speak, let's keep the one voice that everybody will hear and follow it up. Not this one will be speaking, this one will be criticizing this one, this one will be criticizing this one. It will become a laughing thing. As this is something that our leader has built for over how many years, and people are just making it as if it's a child's play.
Thank you.
We in Biafra land, we are not happy with what is happening on Facebook. You know, because we in Biafra land, we don't always have money to buy data and all those things. There are some people in the diaspora, because they are using Wi-Fi or free data, you see somebody will just come out and be misleading people, telling people to do this one, dividing the whole house, which is this. But that is not what we need at this point in time.
Thank you.
That is not what we need at this point in time. We need to work in togetherness to achieve our aim, to achieve what we are looking for. Biafra is our destination. According to our leader, it's either Biafra or nothing.
Thank you.
So I want to thank you and may Chukwuka Abiama continue to strengthen our media warriors.
You too.
So we'll be able to hit the Fulani Chandawis at very well. If you check out, for how many days now, the person that is exposing Nigeria, the suit, is just Amonepa. The other ones are busy gossiping. Every day, Samonepa, gossiping Samonepa. And Samonepa is busy doing his work that God has assigned him to do.
Thank you, Pastor.
Please, the DOS need to come up and stop all these things that are happening. Thank you very much.
Thank you. God bless you for a wonderful contribution. Bishop, you're welcome, sir. Thank you. Bishop, good evening, sir. Can you hear me?
Yeah, I can hear you. I don't know if you can hear me, my brother.
Yeah, I'm hearing you very clear. I just came back from work, head full. I said, let me address our people. I was even expecting that you would come. That's why I put the code on the line, so anybody can come in. So we are here already 2 hours plus. You know, it's not easy. And Bishop, you know, today I'm treating a very special topic, which I didn't even discuss with you, but I know as a wise man of Biafra, you know, based on what I have been trending, although we spoke today, but you know, on your own thinking, who actually can bring our people together? Now, the people has gone into autopilot. Nobody believes DOS. According to one of our brother, maybe you have seen when I played his voice, one brother from down there, I'm still going to play his voice. Then you pick something. The brother said the people said no to sit at home because they want to hear from Mazina and the Kano. Then I put it to the people, our viewers here, that the people are good followers. IPOBs and Biafrans are good followers because we are doing the spiritual thing. Do you know that the disciples of Jesus Christ, they call them the good sheep who follows the voice of the good shepherd? So I said maybe they want to hear from Mazina and the Kano. This is what I was thinking before I made this particular Akuse video that I'm going to show
you. Mildness from the people's heart.
I'm going to rewind it.
There's nobody you can.
Then from there you will go.
On Tuesday,
yeah,
after Bishop's conference in Owerri,
yeah,
they resolved that IPOB should suspend the every Monday exercise. Originally, that is biting hard on the economy of the Southeast. They said they now resolved that any day that Anambra will be coming to court, that will be affected. But unfortunately, people are not, you know, don't have that confidence to come out. Auditing is responsible.
The problem is that the people that are resolving that IPOP my everything and people should come out, I believe they are in order by saying that the whole thing will be done like that. But there's something they forgot. People is already fearing. This is number one. And number two, people believe that Nnamdi Kanu is in DSS custody. Then number three, they should allow Nnamdi Kanu to speak from DS custody to create mildness from the people's heart. Because there's nobody you can trust now. Even the other people that say that they are DOS and the IPOP, there's a little confusion. So the best, if Nigerian and Biafra wanted to do the best thing, let them allow Nnamdi Kanu to speak boldly.
Thank you, Bishop. So now, let's move forward. Yeah. And I don't know what is your take on that, our brother's action, you know, because people, I think the people want to hear from Mazin Nnamdi Kanu. So what do you think about that one?
Thank you, my brother. First of all, I want to commend you, my guy. You know, it's not easy to burn your data and always be there for Biafrans to listen to you. because at a point, at a time like this, everybody want to, you know, listen to somebody else apart from you yourself, because our people say that the problem shared is a problem solved. So before I go on this issue of sit at home, I want to, you know, say something concerning what the last caller said about and even you yourself about our beloved brother Simon Ekpa, the issue that is going on between him and the DOS. I'm not trying to go deep into that matter, but I just want to, you know, figure something out there, so that I believe by saying all this thing at a point of time, people may come to the understanding of what is going on. You know, the way everything is going on is because of many people are confused due to lack of information. I am an IPOP member. We don't hide our face. We don't hide our identity. Okay? So I can say that what is happening between Simon Ekpa and DOS is just what I can call lack of submission, because when two groups are, you know, competing or trying having arguments or something, at a point of time one of them can say, let me submit, and the only person that I am directing my word to this night is our beloved brother Simon Ekpa. I want him to know one thing about this issue that is on ground. Biafrans loves him so much. Even this DOS of a people, if they don't love Simon Ekpa, they will not be going far. If they don't need his service, if they see him as somebody that is irrelevant, somebody that have nothing to offer, believe me, you, this matter will not be trending. So I want to let Simon Ekpa to know that Biafrans love him and they want his service. IPOP want him and they need his service. DOS want him. Nnamdi Kanu need him, and that's why he's recommending for his service. DOS have seen that our leader recommendation of him is important. That's why they want him to do what he's supposed to do. Now, being somebody that is into IPOP, let me use this opportunity to tell those that don't know how he rolled, the how he goes. In IPOP, we have series of oaths. One person can take more than 20 oaths. It depends on services. It depends on area you are called, or they can call you tomorrow. Okay? So now, in this issue of Simon Ekpa, he took oath with our leader Nnamdi Kanu, because when you look at the way the whole thing is trending, I can categorically tell you here that Simon Ekpa have not took oath in the mix of IPOP family meeting. He have not done that. And that's the reason why all this thing is going this way. And this time around, Biafrans need his service. IPOP need his service. And because they need his service, he have to go through what every members of IPOP have gone through. Now, Simon, I have heard him several times, you know, commend IPOP under the leadership of Nnamdi Kanu, how God used them to champion this agitation to the level where they are now. Now, every Biafrans that believe in Biafran struggle today, it was as a result of inspiration of IPOP under the leadership of Nnamdi Kanu. Now, he himself believe in this inspiration, and that is why he's doing what he's doing. And now the IPOPs need his service, Biafrans need his service, and there is no other place he can render this service now except in IPOP. I am telling you the truth. There is no other place he can render this service now except in IOP. I'm not trying to say that what he's doing is not good. He has been doing a great job. That's why he was even attracted our leaders' attention and even IPOP attention to the level the whole thing is now. So now, because we need his service, for instance, look at the way everything started. This young man has been doing a marvelous job, even working with our leader all this while. And it happened that when our leader is away, he recommended that he should now go into IPOP and start broadcasting. on Radio Biafra. And on doing that, he must pass through the family of IPOP before going to that Radio Biafra. Likewise, every other services that our leader wants him to render to Biafras. Now, when he come to family meeting, first of all, the family member of IPOP, they know him. They will not say that they don't know him. But first of all, there is no way IPOP will receive him in their midst. Because, for instance, where I am now, if we come to our meeting, every meeting day, we don't discuss anything until we find out those that have come for the first time. And immediately we discover those that are there for the first time, they will first of all go the normal process before the meeting will start. So, being that we know Simon, but does not mean that if he come to our meeting here now, you know me, where we are now, if he come here before he will do anything, he will first of all take oath before we even discuss anything with him. That is how he runs. Even if oath member where he's coming from, he must still take oath with us before we continue any meeting. That is how he runs. Now, I can say today that what is happening today, our beloved brother Simon Ekpa should know that it is a call for service. We are like, you know, we need him. Okay, for instance, what if it happened today now that our leader from where he is now decide that Namkalu Simon Ekpa should take the lead. He should now take the lead. Where is he going to lead? Is he not in IPOP? Is he going to create another group to champion the struggle? He already believe in IPOP, and the level he believe in IPOP, I don't think he can refuse anything that is a process of rendering service to Biafrans through IPOP. So I beg him. I read something on his page today where he was talking about the IPOP in Finland. You know, they are distancing themselves from the person that wrote the memo. He is in Finland. Let him organize that Finland IPOP. Yeah, let him, you know, go to them, do what he's supposed to do, show them that he's one of them. There is nothing wrong about all these things. We need him. And as far as Biafrans need him now, and there is no other platform, unless if you want just to continue doing the way he's doing now. But we need more service from him now. Even our leader, if our leader knew that it will be like this, I'm not trying to say that he don't know, but if our leader knew that it will be like this, he could not even allow this to happen in the first place. He will be the one that will, you know, make sure that this our brother do what he's supposed to do before this time. So hence is something that happened by accident. Is not our way, and he need this man. He need this our brother service. Let him do what he's supposed to do, because I don't see any platform that is going to do all this job except in IPOP. So it is a simple thing. Let him just go to IPOP Finland, you know. Let them recognize him. Let them knew him. Let them, you know, make sure that he do what he's supposed to do, and the whole thing is settled. So to me, is the right thing that he's supposed to do now. All this thing is a call for service. He should know that it's a call for service. It's not any other thing. We are calling him for service. Even DOS, they are calling him for service. And as far as he want him to serve us in another dimension, we want him to serve us in another level, there are things he's supposed to do, because there is no other place he's going to do that except in IPOP. He has been doing a great job, but now we need him. We need him inside this movement more than ever before. For that reason, he must do what he's supposed to do. It is a laid down role that our leader have established for so many years. And if IPOP is successful today, there are things that made them to be successful. So, and this is one of it. And he cannot just come and ignore all those things. So I am calling on Simon Ekpa today, please. It is a call for service. It's not, I don't know if anybody have abused you or they have insulted you, but I would like you, as a man of wisdom you are, to understand what is going on now that Biafrans are calling you for service. So we are not disagreeing that you have not took any oath before, but we want you to have a family. We want you to have a family in IPOP, a family that can testify tomorrow that you are one of them, because we need your service now. So that's what I want to say about having
you. Yeah, still on the Simon Ekpa's things, you know, today we're going to cut it. I'm already 2 hours plus here. Family's upstairs. So now, Bishop, based on the still good point that you rose now, the way the Finland families wrote the letter and they spread it on the net, you know, to bully Simon Ekpa, and also the way, I would say, China Sanworu came online and begin to broadcast about it. Do you think is the accurate way to do it?
My brother, to me, let's stop, you know, going that way, looking who is right and who is wrong.
All right.
Okay.
Thank you.
I've already said it here that all this is just misinformation, and misunderstanding. Misunderstanding can rise at any time. And if you don't take care of it, it will degenerate to another thing. So whatever
happens,
I can just simply say that is misunderstanding. Okay, look at what happened in this issue of sit at home, because that is the area I'm about to come now. When you look at the way everything is going, my dear, at a point of time there was a misunderstanding between the same DOS and the family of Nnamdi Kanu. Okay, now which the family of Nnamdi Kanu came up to apologize, and at a time even the same DOS now turned back, and they are still now they are asking the same thing that Nnamdi Kanu brother asked in the first place. It's a misunderstanding. It's just something that can occur at any time, but we should not hold on it. We should not keep bombarding it till the kingdom come. So it is a time we should learn or try to move forward, because we have a lot of things at hand. Everybody can see the situation now. You are talking about the issue of sit at home, and when I look at what you wrote, your comment, your topic, you are asking how are they going to reach them? People that have disobeyed, even you were asking if those that sit at home today, if they are disobeying DOS, and if they are disobeying DOS, who is now going to speak to them? My brother, let me tell you one thing. Let me come from that place. I want to tell you one thing, my dear. There is one thing our people don't know, and they should know it now. Okay, very, very simple. In this issue of a Biafra struggle, even in Nnamdi Kanu, even him himself don't know the level God have taken this struggle. If Nnamdi Kanu is out now, he will testify before the whole world that he can't believe that people from the East can rise up to this level. Okay? That is to tell you that something have taken place in the realm of the spirit. This struggle have gone beyond anybody. Even Nnamdi Kanu himself come out today. There are some order he will give about the struggle that people will not cling to. I am telling you the gospel truth. And there's one thing people should know. In this struggle of Biafra, in this issue of Biafra,
I have a call on the line. Please let me pick this call that you consider. Please, thank you.
Okay, no problem.
Yes. Hello, my sister. Oh, hey, Biafra. Can you hear me, ma?
Hello.
Hello, ma. Can you hear me?
I'm hearing you now. Good evening.
Good evening.
I believe I'm calling on your show.
Yes. Let me see. Yes.
You may call because the number is full. I try to call you, I cannot find you.
Oh, that
then
is.
I decide to call you on Facebook.
Right on, you are still connected.
Hope I'm not interrupting.
No, no problem. You are still connected. Yes.
Okay. Let me just tell you the reason why I called. Yeah. Good evening, everyone.
Good evening.
Good morning. Good afternoon. Good night. depending when you are going to listen to this video. You know, the reason why I called, you see, this Biafra struggle, I find out that many Igbo Biafras, they are jealous of each other. I'm sorry to say it. They are very, very jealous of each other. Then another thing again, many people, what they don't know about struggle for freedom, yeah? You might start this struggle for freedom with our great, great, great Mazi Nnamdi Kanu. That doesn't mean our Mazi must tell you, okay, continue to broadcast in a Biafra IPOB radio when he is not around. People are jealous of that. You might start to do IPOB for many, many years. Somebody will come to this. The potential that they can provide, you may not have it. And another thing again, you see, in this Europe, there are different stages people can go. And in this Europe, many of us, one thing or the other, yeah, I'm just talking in general, that's my way of life. One thing or the other, people have put their hands in what they're not supposed to put their hands. For that simple reason, they are some lines. They have to match as a woman or as a man. They can't do it. Should I shock many people who call themselves Igbo Biafran? Do you see many, many lines, yeah? Because many of you don't know, you just see it like it's normal. This struggle we are all fighting for, there are some things you will face with your internet in your house, yeah? There are some things you will face. Interpol will knock at your door. Many of you don't know. For you, as an individual, as an IPOB, whether Igbo Biafra speaking, whether Igbo Domestico speaking, Biafra speaking, whether Agbo, be it anything, as far as Biafra is concerned, yeah? You see many, many expositions, Mazi Tamepa is bringing out to make many people brave. So know many, many things. But you know, there are some things our great leaders, yeah, don't even remember to even talk about. Do you know that Mazi Tamepa is bringing it out? Are you people aware of it?
For sure.
Many of you just see it like, okay, let me talk, I want to talk. No. Before our great leader, Mazi Nnamdi Kanu, before he tells Sami Ekpa, Mazi Sami Ekpa, to talk on Radio Biafra, he knows what he was doing. And let me also tell many of you, saying that you must take oath in RPOB, you must take oath in RPOB. Let me tell you something. You don't take oath, yeah? The meaning of that word, RPOB, it means Indigenous People of Biafra.
Exactly.
So whether you take oath or you don't take oath, you are a Biafra. And if one of these Ekpa is going to take oath, not all this one, every Dick and Harry is talking in fact, you must take oath, you must take oath, you must take oath. Did you bring him abroad? Ekpa has been through for you to have a lot of wisdom he has in his head, for him to have capacity, for him to have intelligence, for him the will, for the masculine, the meaning of this amendment, the emphasis, for you as a being. Many years ago, you can see march on many toes where people don't even remember to march on. So I expose them to the whole world. That was the reason as Ekpa speaks on Radio Biafra. if I'm not around. He didn't do it because he loved him so much. No. He asked him to do that because he knows he's ready to expose anything exposable, even if it's not around. And really, really, Moses and Bethel gave it to heaven. So what does these people want for him? Must you force somebody to do something? Somebody like me, when you force me to do something, I'm not going to do away with that thing. That I'm
Hello, Austin.
Okay, thank you.
Many people,
thank you, my sister.
Let him do what he's doing. Can you pay him to do what he's doing? Sometimes he doesn't do sleep. He knows he's going to work. Can you do it?
Thank you. Thank you, my sister. We are running out of time. That's why, you know. So
I'm very angry for all these things that are going on.
Thank you.
I'd like to respond to. Taking much time, sir.
Thank you, sister. Thank you so much. So now let's move forward.
Let me stop here.
Thank you. Yes, thank you. Yeah. So you know, because I'm running out of time. The stream yard is already almost. So I said on 3 hours. We have 2 hours at the 3. So almost. Let me say 22 minutes now. We have done here. Bishop. So. Now, I do want to say anything based on what our sister Mercy Koko has said.
Yes, I wanted to respond to her
from Igodomigo.
But it's like we are talking. Okay. Hence, I believe she can still hear me.
She's hearing our sister Mercy Koko.
Our sister should understand one thing. Nobody is trying to force Simon Ekpa to do what he don't want to do. After all, he have already started doing it. There's nothing like forcing him to do what he don't want to do because he's already doing it.
There is another point she raised there.
I picked one point from what right. She's saying.
Okay.
So, but that is the area that I want to clear. She said a lot. I'm not ready to respond to all that he said, but I just want to respond to one point that he made concerning Simon Ekpa, that he said, number one, that IPOP is indigenous people of Biafra. Yes, everybody is a Biafra. If you are from Eastern region, you are an IPOP. That is number one. Mm-hmm. If you are from the Eastern region, you are indigenous people of Biafra. Your service is expected. Anything you can render, anything. You can belong, you can be there at any time, as far as Biafra is mentioned, because you are a member, you are not even a member, you are indigenous people of Biafra. So now, but there is one something that people should understand here. She still said one thing, that nobody can force Simon Ekpa to do what he don't want to do. No, it is not, that is not correct. And he still say that not everybody, is no more that he can do, he can accept to do everything before he render the service. I want to clear our sister so that she will understand where all this thing is coming from. This movement of IPOP was started by somebody, and that person is Nnamdi Kanu. You and I that is talking about Biafra today, if not by this man, of his services and his wisdom and grace that God gave to him, you and I will not be talking about Biafra. And this man founded IPOP. And he founded this IPOP under some structure. He invested his wisdom, his knowledge, to make this movement succeed to where it is today. And in one of the wisdom that he invested is this oath of a thing. I am not going to mention everything that is going on in IPOP.
Yes.
Now, first of all, he formed a group, and he named this group Indigenous People of Biafra. He formed a group, and he took this name from Biafrans, and he gave this name to that group that he formed. He gave them that name, Indigenous People of Biafra. And before you are a Biafran, you are an indigenous people of Biafra. But if you want to join this group, there are some processes you must go before you join this group. That is to say, as a Biafran, as indigenous people of Biafra, there are some services. Any day you wake up, you feel that, what these people are doing is good. I want to render help to them. I want to render services to them. You can render your service to them. But there are some services. If you come to that point, there are some processes you must go. For instance, people are contributing to ESN from all parts of this world. Even those that are Biafra and those people that are not from Biafra, their services is limited. Their service, they can render their services with even those services have some process, because before you contribute to ESN, you must go the process of banking. It's either you go through your account, you go through transfer, or you go to family member of IPOP and you give the money to them. It's a process. You can't just sit in your house and say, I contribute to ESN, and the money will fly and go to ESN. You must go through banking system, and it's a process. If you are in Europe and want to send the money to America, you go through banking system. It's a process. Now, exactly. It's the same thing. As an indigenous people of Biafra you are, and you see that what these people are doing is good, you want to render a service that required your presence, that require you going to their meeting, sitting with them. When you go to their meeting, there are some process to attend their meeting. Now, if you want to render a service, maybe they want to send you to an era. Nnamkalu can call somebody and say, I want to send you to an era, and is consigned this struggle. He will just stand there and enter out with you. You can go to that era and come back. So there are many services and different procedure. So it's not something about everybody is an indigenous people of Biafra. You have your right. Yes, you have your right, but the same man that founded this IPOP, he's the one that set this structure. And he set that structure, there are processes you must go through before you render service to IPOP or you render service to Biafras. So people should, look at what is going on today, because this is the area I want to go now. What is happening in the East today? Are you trying to tell me that everybody that is obeying this sit at home is a member of IPOP? They are indigenous people of Biafra. They are the one that have taken it upon themselves to do what they are doing now. And any day, any of them say, in fact, I am waking up now. Where is those IPOP group? I want to join them. The person will not go through the process. It's a simple thing. It's not by force, or it's something you have to do willingly. That's why I was saying today that our brother Simon Ekpa should know that we need his service. What he has been doing before, we need him to do more than what he's doing now. And because his services is required to another level now, that is the reason why they are calling for this process. You cannot say you love Nnamdi Kanu. You cannot say you love IPOP and you go contrary to what Nnamdi Kanu have already placed there. If Nnamdi Kanu is out now, if Nnamdi Kanu come out here today, he can never side Simon Ekpa to go to Finland, IPOP family member, and begin to participate with them there without taking oath. He can never side it, because he's the one that established it. Let people understand this thing. Let people understand it. Nnamdi Kanu have been recommending Simon by sending him message, coming to a level they want to have interview, and he took oath. Now,
okay, let's move forward, because because of the time, we have to cut it. I have 10 minutes to go, before we lose everything.
Let me now come to the issue of sit at home. I want DOS, because you are asking for you are asking who will now go and talk to them, the people that disobey,
who can the people that are sitting at home.
The people that are sitting at home now, if they are disobeying DOS And if they are doing that, who will now go and talk to them? My brother, let me tell you one thing. We should not even think about who we go and talk to them. That one is not what we should be talking about now. And DOS should not waste their energy anymore or talking about this sit-at-home issue. Let them start telling us the next line of action. I'm telling the gospel truth. You see, this matter of sit-at-home, this one is beyond even Nnamdi Kanu until Biafra see him. Okay? There's one thing you should know. From all the informations that we are receiving since our issue of this sit-at-home start, some people said, from Simon, I heard it from him, he said that this information is coming from our leader, Nnamdi Kanu. And the reason is that you should not be fast, because what is coming is bigger than sitting at home. He was trying to, defend that sit at home supposed to be canceled. That is the reason why he went to that length. But let me tell you the truth. If it is true that the reason why the sit at home was canceled is because everybody should work now, because very soon what is bigger than sit at home will come. Biafra have said that they are ready to do all 10. That is what you are seeing now. They have said that they are ready to even give their life for this struggle. Number two, second point is this. Nnamdi Kanu, another information is that Nnamdi Kanu is like having compassion for his people. He don't want his people to suffer hungry. He want them to go to their normal daily activities to look for what they will eat. That is a very good point. But the people of Biafra have chosen to suffer with Nnamdi Kanu because he's not enjoying in that DOS. So that is what he has seen. If that one is the reason, they have already chosen to suffer their own, because Nnamdi Kanu have given all for us. He have given everything. And Biafra have understand that this man have given all. So they have chosen to give one Monday for him. It's a simple thing. Nobody should start, we should stop arguing on this issue of sit at home and allow people to do what pleases them, because what you are seeing them doing now, in fact, they are driving pleasure on doing it.
Okay,
Bishop. It's giving them relief.
Yeah, before I bring you in, there was a video I want to play. Somebody sent it to me from home. Said, I remind you with this to show you why they don't believe that it was Mazen Nnamdi Kanu. A lot of them don't believe that it was Mazen Nnamdi Kanu. You know, I don't know, you know, but let's listen to this interview that I've been trying to pop up. Then I will give you the last minutes. We have 44 minutes. Let me say in the next 10 minutes, let me play this video and you watch it. Yeah. Thank you. How do I go into it? Right now, here. Sorry.
Confederation.
So, a weak center. What does Biafra mean?
It means freedom, liberty, fairness, equity, and justice.
In practical terms, these are very good sounding words, mm-hmm. But in practical terms, what does Biafra mean?
Confederation.
So, a weak center.
Very weak.
Very strong regions.
Absolutely.
Have you had a change of mind, therefore, about getting an independent Biafra? Because that's what I seem to be hearing.
No, I've not changed my mind, no. An independent Biafra means going back to the way we were before the white man came.
Okay, so you're not talking about a federation when you say a confederation. You're not talking about a federation as part of Nigeria. You're talking about total independence.
Absolute independence.
Complete independence. Now, is there anything that can happen that will make you change your mind about this particular direction?
No.
So it is either Biafra or nothing else.
Or death, yes.
Or death.
That's correct.
It's push.
Now, Bishop, did you hear that?
Yes.
Somebody posted me this, remind me, I do know it, but you know, sometimes all these old videos need to put into practice. He said, listen, this is not Mazen Nnamdi Kanu in DSS talking. Said the Mazen Nnamdi Kanu he knew, it was a she. He said, this is the Mazen and the Kano. So these are the things. That is what I'm telling you. I said, the Biafrans know the voice of their shepherd, they're the sheep. So I don't know. So that's why the man in the market said they should allow Mazen and the Kano to calm the situation. That's why I said, who can talk to the people? So Bishop, please, you have 46 minutes. Let's say the next 12 minutes, use it and round it up. Then I will conclude the end. Then tomorrow another day.
Thank you. So from what you had our leader say, when you is what you hear him say now is not the first time. This is the person of Nnamdi Kanu. This is his character. This is his speech. Whenever he speak, you see the spirit in him. So, but bringing this speech now to what is happening today is another thing, and you can still play this role that you are seeing now on ground. If people don't believe that Nnamdi Kanu is the one speaking from DOS, are you going to argue with that? I am not going to argue with that.
I'm also not arguing.
Yeah, because it can be true. It can be true that Nnamdi Kanu is not the one speaking. Nobody can, if you come before God now, you cannot argue it before God that some people are saying that it's not Nnamdi Kanu that is speaking from you, because it can happen. And let me put it clear to you. Even if it is Nnamdi Kanu that is speaking from DOS, DSS, my dear, the people said, release him for us. If it's not Nnamdi Kanu and you are playing game, that is to say the people have catch up with your game. It's a simple thing.
Exactly.
And they are telling you that we don't want to believe what you are saying. Release this man for us. What are we fighting here? Do you know the problem that sometimes we are facing is that we don't like to talk the truth the way it is. There are issues that Biafra is supposed to be talking now, not issue of who gave order and who did not give order, sit at home or not sit at home. Simple, the people of Biafra have chosen to sit at home, even if Nnamdi Kanu is the one. They said no to this very one until they see him. And if you want to prove them wrong, releasing Nnamdi Kanu is a simple thing. There are some issues that when you look at it, you will even be more angry to sit where people are debating about this issue of sit at home or not sit at home. The same Nigeria that went and kidnapped Nnamdi Kanu from Kenya are the same Nigeria, the same government today that are defending Abba Kyari from FBI that came to arrest him for so many days now. They are going through due process. There are things that we don't supposed to be, killing ourselves. We should focus our energy to the right argument. The same Nigeria that don't want us to see Nnamdi Kanu, that want us to be hearing from him, from the dungeon, are the same people that are going due process of Abba Kyari to be taken to United States of America. Is it not the same process? And from what I heard, he Nnamdi Kanu case is a political case.
Pure political case.
His case is the one that is supposed to go this process they are going now.
Exactly.
Abba Kyari case is a criminal case. And these people have investigated him, go to court, they got court order from US. They are just here for you to look into all the report that they have and handle the man over to him. But now, handle the man over to them, but they are going due process now. They want to go to the court, they want to do this, they want to do what they're supposed to do before they will handle the man over to FBI. And in the case of Nnamdi Kanu, they just capture him and they brought him to Nigeria. Now they put him in DSS office and they want us to be hearing Nnamdi Kanu speaking from DSS. If anybody that this issue is paining him, let that person release Nnamdi Kanu. Simple. and the matter will go.
Let me play the voice of the former DSS Akuse officer or whatever, or commander. I don't know what they call himself. And I think he's an Igbo man. Now, watch what he's saying. Watch what this man is saying. How he was very happy. Then you will round up from there. Then we call it a day. Let me put his voice. Then you will hear this man.
Shocked in the sense that we were not expecting this kind of arrest. And that shows the collaborative effort of our security agencies. And the issue of this arrest is a major one.
He called it arrest, but it's a kidnapping.
Security agency, because Nigeria, we must all agree, is drifting to the precipice. We have a lot of security challenges. And nobody is against Nnamdi Kanu's agitation for Biafra, but should be done in a proper manner, not with criminality. He has led a lot of people who have lost their lives innocently with this agitation. And he's outside the country propagating Biafra. So the main thing for him, I believe, he should come into Nigeria and lead his people so that they follow him.
Now he's leading them.
People are losing their lives. I abhor criminality. That's the most important thing. Because even though it must be noted too that Nnamdi Kanu has said that they are not responsible for the killings in the East, but we should have surprise to me that they could just effect the arrest simply like that, because of he has made a lot of noise and has a large followership, and it's a very healthy development for me as a person.
Do you see what he called it?
Has been arrested or rearrested and is to be arraigned. Do you see these as restoring peace to the Southeast, or what do you foresee happening going forward?
I foresee a situation where people should at least respect the rule of law. Go on for your agitation, yes, no doubt, but follow due process. In the Southwest, for
instance. Bishop, please, let me just pause this man. He know what he's doing. Follow due process. Follow due process. Follow due process. The Fulani
talking about, you know, that's the reason why I don't like listening to people like this, because he's just doing his job. He's just playing his pocket, his politics for his pocket. Okay?
Thank you.
He said that if Nnamdi Kanu want to, that nobody is against his agitation, but he should go
due process.
Abi?
Yes.
Due process. Somebody from the House of Assembly raised the motion of dividing Nigeria. You saw what happened there now. Is it not the normal house, the normal place to
bring the
normal place to present the matter? If anybody want a breakup of Nigeria or anything related to that, is it not inside House of Assembly that such a thing should be discussed? Now, somebody raised the issue there. This man that is talking here now, he saw what happened there. He didn't make any video. Now, the same Nnamdi Kanu that he's talking about was in Nigeria leading a peaceful protest. Outside Nigeria and inside Nigeria, leading a peaceful protest, and they were killing them like chicken. Did you hear any video from this man telling Nigeria government to stop killing these people, that they are doing what they're supposed to do? Now, he's telling us that Nnamdi Kanu should come back to Nigeria and lead his people. The same Nnamdi Kanu was leading his people in a peaceful manner all over the eastern part of Nigeria, okay, in a peaceful manner. Nobody, throughout those days, those time, you didn't hear that anybody's fowl lost. You didn't hear that anybody's shop were break. You didn't hear that any school children were kidnapped. You didn't hear that any police were killed. You didn't hear that any village was attacked. You didn't hear that anybody was attacked in the farmland. You didn't hear it. He was leading his people in a normal way, and the same government that with this that man
gun,
is representing.
With that gun and bullet, when,
you know, they have never, anywhere they had a rally, you will never hear that somebody's wallet lost. But this very man, this very man you are seeing here today with his government, they went to his house to kill him. And on the process, they killed 28 people. Okay? He didn't make any video that time to say to Nigeria government that what you people did is evil.
Mm.
But he's here speaking nonsense English. He said that is a collaboration. A collaboration with who? It's a collaboration with who? United Kingdom have denied that they are not involved in extradition. The even Kenya government have denied them. Now, which collaboration with who? You see, if you, that's why I'm telling people that if you are still listening to people like this, you have missed everything, my brother. So to summarize, there was a time our people used to say that Igbos don't have my brother. There is something I observe about the Easterners. They are not easy to convince, but if you try to convince them, you will see their support.
With
is exactly what happened in 2014 election, I think so, or to either 2014 or 2006, the second to the last election that Goodluck Jonathan conducted before he lost. You will see how massive support that man received from the East. In fact, only eastern part of Nigeria gave him more than 40% of vote that he needed to win that election. But immediately he messed them up. They dropped him. 2015 election with Buhari. They just turned back on him. They didn't vote him. Okay? That is Igbos for you. Just convince them with the truth and you will see their support. So I am advising both politicians, both saboteurs, both DOS, both IPOP, both everybody that are involved in this matter of sit at home. What you people should be doing now is this. Plan on how to bring Nnamdi Kanu out. Because that place he is, he have not committed any offense bigger than Abba Kyari own. That place that he is, he have not committed any offense bigger than Sunday Igbohu own. He is doing the same job that Sunday Igbohu is doing. Okay? And Sunday Igbohu is not in DSS dungeon. Okay? They should be planning on how to bring him out so that all this thing will be over. And secondly, I am using your platform this evening to talk to DOS. The issue of sit at home is over. Okay? You people have how received a sound message from Biafrans. And one thing you people should know is that every Biafrans today are not IPOP member. Okay? 60% of people championing this sit at home, they are not even IPOP member. That's what you people should know. They don't abide by your rule. They don't abide by your command and control. What they are looking at is what they feel that they will do for Nnamdi Kanu, and wherever he is, he will be happy with them. Everybody wants to sacrifice his own, because before, many IPOP members always condemn these people. That they are always busy with their business, busy with their shop, busy with their this. This is the time that all of them want to participate in this struggle. And they are happy doing it. I watch many videos today. Many are eating pepper soup, you know, drinking, enjoying themselves. They have already seen it as an avenue to celebrate this man, Nnamdi Kanu. So it's not issue of arguing again. What DOS should focus on now is this. They say that they are coming up with a strong, bigger condition action than now. Let them come up quick with that action so that one will suppress this one and we move forward. So issue of this sit at home will not be an argument again, because I don't think, for what I saw happen today, nobody can convince these people again to go back from what they have decided. So that is my advice to the US. Thank you, my brother.
Thank you. Nice to have you. Our time is really off. Bishop, I appreciate you. So thank you so much. Maybe tomorrow we are going to be here live again. So nice to see you. Greetings to your whole family, Bishop. So I will be with you again tomorrow to unfold anything based on the matters arising. I appreciate.
Thank you, my brother. Thank you, my brother. You're welcome.
Wow, yeah. Nice. Okay, that is Bishop, and it was a very nice day with Bishop who here online. Like you all know, this is a wise man of Biafra, and I wish to have him tomorrow again. Biafrans, all of you have seen our M tonight. The question was, like, since the Biafrans has taken their agitation and their power into their hand, who is going to calm them? Many of them who are on the ground has called and said nobody can stop them because they are in solidarity with Mazin Nandekano. Many say that they want Mazin Nandekano to speak from anywhere he is. So it is left now for the the southern governors, if they don't want more problems on seat at home, they must be able to allow Mazin Nandekano to be released unconditionally. They are the one who put him there. So we're waiting for the freedom of Mazin Nandekano, who was extraordinarily indicted by the help of Kenyans and also the British. And we are waiting for the release of Mazin Nandekano. Also, we want to thank all the DOS. All of us who are working hard. We want to thank someone, but thanking our leader Mazin Nandekano and the entire Biafran squad. God will bless everybody. And also for the saboteurs back there who are thinking that we are fighting. We are not fighting anything. We have family issues that we are fixing already, by only understanding ourselves, and everything is working good for us. So Biafra is our goal, and Biafra is our religion. We have no other God but the God of our land. Biafra is what we believe, and Biafra we shall get. I want to thank every one of you who has participated on sharing this particular platform. I will say, may God bless all of you as you be with me tomorrow again. I am your brother, Mazi Okonkwo. All hail Biafra, all hail Mazin Nandekano. Goodbye.